بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته كلنا وناكسن دا وضياء الشقيمة هي قدرين تمضل هو ميل والبا جوكتان ومركلة اي برنامج كي عود كجالية دا كندا وادوغا براتين حلية دا نوكلة إنو إدين كغي مادو استوديها تلبيشن كقران كسوماليا وكل إيها مقالة دا تورنتو إدالك كندا وحانا برنامج كا هل كان إدين كغسو قد بنا إياه أنيقو أهم حدين جامعة barnaamijkeena todobaadkan daawadayaal waxa aynu ku soo qaadanaynaa bulshada Soomaaliyeed ee ku dhaqan magaalada Ottawa ee gobolka Ontario ee dalkan Canada iyadoo tir ahaan lagu qiyaasay 530 kun dadka Soomaaliyeed ee tirada inta la eegay degan magaalada Ottawa waxa ay qayb ka yihiin bulshooyinka kale ee ku dhaqan magaaladaasi Ottawa hadii ay noqon lahayd mid dhaqaale iyo mid waxbarasho ah dadka Soomaaliyeed ee ku nool magaaladaasi Ottawa waxa ay xirfadahooda kala duwan ay kaga shaqeeyaan haday noqon lahayd dawladda hoose gobolka iyo dawladda federaalka qaar koodna ay u shaqeeyaan shirkado caalami ah oo ku yaala magaaladaasi Ottawa hadaba horumarka baaxadda leh ee bulshada Soomaaliyeed ee ku dhaqan magaalada Ottawa ayaa todobaadkan waxa aynu ku soo qaadanayna dugsiga ku yaala magaaladaasi Ottawa oo la yiraahdo Ottawa Islamic School dugsigaasi waxa la furay sanadkii 2004 waxaana dugsigaasi dhigta arday Soomaaliyeed iyo ardayda muslimiinta ah ee degan magaalada Ottawa sanadkii 13aad ayaa dugsigaasi waxaa loo sameeyay xaflad qalin jabin ah ardayda dugsiga sare ee ka soo baxda iyo ardayda dugsiga dhexe ee iyagu u soo gudubta dugsiga sare iyo kuwa dugsiga hoose oo iyagu u soo gudba dugsiga dhexe hadaba todobaadkii la soo dhaafay ayaa waxaa lagu qabtay kulliyadda Algon Queen xaflad qalin jabin ah oo aad u ballaaran oo ay soo abaabuleen maamulka iyo gudiga dugsigaasi Ottawa Islamic School xafladaasi oo ay ka soo qayb galeen dadweyne aad u far badan marti si gaar ah loogu marti qaaday waalidiinta barnaamijkaasi waxa aan xiriirinayay laba arday oo ka tirsan dugsiga sare ee Ottawa Islamic School oo kala ah Amar Abdi Samad iyo Leila Shinawi
The peace, mercy and blessings of Allah be upon you all. My name is Amar Abdi Samad and I just completed the 11th grade at the Ottawa Islamic School which also happened to be my 13th year at the school. Indeed, it is an honor for me and my fellow classmate Leila Al-Shinawi to be your MCs during the commencement ceremony of the graduating class of 2016.
Thank you and Jazakallah Khairan Amar. Ladies and gentlemen, brothers and sisters, we are gathered here to celebrate the success of our 13th graduating class since 2004. Today, we commend them on their relentless efforts and hard work and wish them continuing success in the future. On behalf of our school staff, students and parents, please welcome Ottawa Islamic School's graduating class of 2016.
Give thanks to Allah for the moon and the stars. Praise Him all day for what is and what was. Take hold of your iman, don't give in to shaitan. Oh, you who believe, please give thanks to Allah. Allahu Ghafoor, Allahu Rahim, Allahu Yuhibbul Muhsinin, Wa Khaliquna, Wa Raziquna, Wa Huwa Ala Kulli Shay'in Qadir. Allah is Ghafoor, Allah is Rahim, Allah is the one who loves the Muhsinin. He is our creator, He is our sustainer, and He is the one who has power over all. Give thanks to Allah for the moon and the stars. Praise Him all day for what is and what was. Take hold of your iman, don't give in to shaitan. Oh, you who believe, please give thanks to Allah. Allahu Ghafoor, Allahu Rahim, Allahu Yuhibbul Muhsinin, Wa Khaliquna, Wa Raziquna, Wa Huwa Ala Kulli Shay'in Qadir. Allah is Ghafoor, Allah is Rahim, Allah is the one who loves the Muhsinin. He is our creator, He is our sustainer, and He is the one who has power over all. Give thanks to Allah for the moon and the stars. Praise Him all day.
One of the grade 12 graduates, Abdurrahman Noor, will begin the ceremony with a heartwarming recitation of a few verses from the Noble Quran, Surah Al-Hujurat. Please welcome Abdurrahman to the stage.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اجتنبوا كثيرا من الظن إن بعد الظن إثم ولا تجسسوا ولا يغتب بعضكم بعضا أيحب أحدكم أن يأكل لحم أخيه ميتا فكرهتموه واتقوا الله إن الله تواب رحيم يا أيها الناس إنا خلقناكم من ذكر وأنثى وجعلناكم شعوبا وقبائل لتعارفوا إن أكرمكم عند الله أتقاكم إن الله عليم خبير قالت الأعراب آمنا قل لم تؤمنوا ولكن قولوا أسلمنا ولما يدخل الإيمان في قلوبكم وإن تطيعوا الله ورسوله لا يردكم من أعمالكم شيئا إن الله غفور رحيم إنما المؤمنون الذين آمنوا بالله ورسله ثم لم يرتابوا وجاهدوا بأموالهم وأنفسهم في سبيل الله أولئك هم الصادقون قل أتعلمون الله بدينكم والله يعلم ما في السماوات وما في الأرض والله بكل شيء عليم يمنون عليك أن أسلموا قل لا تمنوا علي إسلامكم بل الله يمن عليكم أن هداكم للإيمان إن كنتم صادقين إن الله يعلم غيب السماوات والأرض والله بصير بما تعملون.
Jazakallah khair, Abdurrahman Noor, for the beautiful recitation. Before we begin this joyous ceremony, let me remind you to be considerate to those around you by refraining from talking during the ceremony, turning off your cell phones, and keeping your children seated near you at all times, please.
We now wish to call upon our dear principal, Brother Muhammad Ahmed, to welcome our guests and to say a few words.
Bismillah, alhamdulillah, wa la ilaha illallah, wa al-aqibatu lil-muttaqin wa la'udana illa ala al-zalimin. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. First of all, I thank all of you for compromising a lot of important engagements to be here with us this historic moment for the grade 12 graduates of Ottawa Islamic School's 2015 and 2016 academic year. I thank Sheikh and Imam Sikandar from KMA, our own Sheikh Ismail and also Imam of AMA, As-Sunnah Muslim Association, Sheikh Muhammad Badat, who could not attend today only because his father has been critically ill in Toronto, and who we all ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless him, his father, with health, inshallah. I also thank a very special guest, Honorable Anita van der Bell, MP of our riding, Ottawa West Nepean, the parents who deserve nothing but a hero's reception and gratitude, an alumnus who was my former student as well, and a current Ottawa police officer, Abdullah Ahmed, who will be one of our speaking guests, media representatives, and the rest of the audience. Thank you all for coming and sharing with us this extremely important moment of the life of our graduating class of 2015 and 2016. Over the years, The school has been producing droves of future doctors, engineers, nurses, health scientists, and the like. And I cannot help but express my pride and gratitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, first and foremost. But the day, I must say, belongs to the latest group of graduates who made us, all of us, proud to celebrate with them. One of the most compelling statistics is that the graduates like you, who graduated from 2004 to 2011, of those, 73% acquired at least a bachelor or a college diploma, at least. Over 90% of them having attained a university degree between their fourth year and the seventh year. Of course, graduates of 2012 and beyond, we still expect them to be continuing, although I already know some of the 2012 graduates already graduated with a degree. If the same statistical trend continues, and there's no reason to believe otherwise, 73% of you today graduates, which means 32 of you, will be sitting with a degree 7 years from now, or at least by the year 2023, if not before that, either a bachelor degree, or a master, or a doctoral degree, or maybe a great help in joining the workforce of Canada or elsewhere, according to the statistics that have been compiled over the years. This is a great achievement on your part and on the part of those who graduated before you. I thank you, all of you, and I thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for giving us this opportunity and this institution. One thing that I must mention is that your diverse destinations, when I explain today, will be a testament to the achievement I'm talking about. 32 of you today are Ontario scholars. That means achieved 80% or more on 6 4U credits. If you also look at the destination that you are going, students, to that area, I compiled together engineering, architecture, and IT together. 11 of you will be going. Biomed, biology, and chemistry, dental hygiene, neuroscience, and health science, 13 of you will be going in that destination. Computer science, 5 students. ESL teaching, development services, developmental services, and child studies, 3 of you will be going in that direction as well. All of you, the students I'm talking about, will be heading to 3 institutions. Carleton University will be leading by claiming 22 of the students here graduates. 9 of the graduates will be going to Ottawa University, and 8 will be going to Algonquin College, which I really encourage, because this is another trend which is developing now, that going to college, after all, is not bad, if not sometimes the best choice to make. 4 students are taking, sorry.4 students decided to take a year off, sometimes while having a good grades, to maybe take off and work rather than paying taking OSAP or some other reasons. So this is the breakdown of your heroes sitting here before you. And I must make those statements so that the parents who have been working very hard over the years of the school life of those children of their own made sure that they turned into the heroes we are seeing them today. And that must be a great piece of information for those parents. I say congratulations, graduates, on this achievement, and thank you for the hard work and steadfastness that you showed in the face of many sleepless nights and worrisome days. Today, you have reaped the benefits and fruits of your hard work, each of you on her or his own pace and interest. You're not all the same, and so are your achievements. That does not mean that some of you should settle for less in life. You just have different potentials and varied preferences. And each one of you should concentrate on one's own strengths, interests, comforts, and capabilities to work to one's own God-given potential. One may not have achieved to his or her potential in high school for reasons that had nothing to do with his or her ability, despite trying with responsibility and self-discipline. But so far, the history of OIS alumni achievement in post-secondary indicates that many modest achievers in high school actually did very, very well. This is an implicit proof that there are secrets associated with this school, preparing students for this day and beyond. And these are feeling proud of oneself and believing in oneself. For that reason, I firmly believe that none of you has a bit of self-doubt, nor has a bit of lack of confidence. I thank and credit that for my colleagues and your educators, teaching and administrative staff alike, who never put you down and never wavered from telling you, keep going, you can do it. My advice to you, as you embark on a totally new and exciting aspect of your journey of life, would be to keep two things in mind. First one, civic engagement and moral responsibility. These two things are the only things I want you to leave as an advice from your elder, probably advisor or teacher. You have what it takes to be a moral citizen with great character as a person simply because of being a product of this great institution, Ottawa Islamic School. You should maximize that with civic responsibility by meeting your responsibilities as a Canadian citizen. I would say volunteering in national, provincial, and municipal institutions that provide public service, helping neighbors, helping seniors, and those in need, and most importantly, keeping and maintaining the peace we enjoy and cherish in our country, Canada. As part of your civic engagement, you should also make sure you know your rights, because those are the ones that keep you going in this country, a country of communities. As a member of a community, you should know your rights as well, while also meeting your responsibilities. This will make you a better citizen. As a Muslim Canadian, you should have the ability to be a constructive citizen, because you are always bound by your feeling that you owe something to your immediate community and to the wider Canadian community. This will allow you to build your piece of great Canadian pie, of the great Canadian pie, and let others do so. Do not let anyone outcompete you in working towards the well-being of this country, nor do you allow anyone to claim they are better citizens than you are. Remember the hadith of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Peace and blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be upon him. And the Prophet said, the best among you is the one whose life benefits others. The best among you is the one whose life benefits others. Thank you. Jazakumullah khair. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Jazakallah khair, Brother Muhammad, for your encouraging words. Now our board member, Brother Muhammad Robla, would like to share a few words with us.
Assalamu alaikum, brother and sister. It's a great honor for me to be here today to bring a greeting and congratulation of the board of the director. As a president of the board, I want to thank you everyone who come here. Chers parents d'élèves, chers étudiants, mesdames, messieurs, c'est un grand honneur pour moi d'être ici aujourd'hui pour vous transmettre les félicitations et les félicitations du conseil d'administration. Principal Brother Mohammed, teachers, honored guests, family, and fellow graduates. Today, I think 45 are graduating from Ottawa Islamic School. The room is full with friends and relatives, and every person here is proud of you and your accomplishment of the goal that you have reached. Aujourd'hui, vous êtes 44 ou 45 diplômés de notre école. La salle est pleine, des amis et des parents, et nous sommes très fiers de vos réalisations. If each of us were to write down a definition of successful graduate, we will quickly discover that some words will be repeated over and over again. The word that I chose it will be dedication, integrity, honesty, and hard work. Si chacun d'entre nous se mettait à décrire une définition de nos diplômés, les mots suivants pourront revenir souvent. Dévouement, la persévérance, l'intégrité, l'honnêteté et le travail dur. Selon moi, la meilleure définition qu'on peut donner à un diplômé d'aujourd'hui, c'est d'être le gagnant. From all terms used to describe a graduate, the one I think should receive the top on the side is a winner. So today, each and every one of you is a winner. You have demonstrated to the hard work, honesty, and dedication that you are a winner. Someone told me one day, the only constant in our life is a change. You started from grade one until grade six is a change. Then starting from grade seven and grade 12 today is a change. And you continue your university or college is a change. So what the great statement that is now relevant for all of us. Today mark culmination of year hard work is a worthy way to celebrate our success or your success. Your family, teacher, and friends all made sacrifice so that you will be successful. They are here to share this rewarding moment with you because they have all played part in you becoming a winner. So let me conclude this one. Please stand and join me in thanking the staff member and family members, friends without whose support you will not have reached in this milestone. So we can give them all the family and friends hand clap for everyone. I and the other member of board members salute your success. Winner accept nothing but the best from themselves. So today I'm telling you, you guys, you are the winner, ladies and boy. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Brother Mohammed Roble. This year, we are privileged to have amongst us a very important member of our community. We are honored to have MP Anita Vandenbeld for Ottawa West Nepean.
Thank you. And thank you so much for that wonderful introduction. And I'm so happy to be here today to see all of the young graduates and your families and your friends. And the most important thing that I can do as a member of parliament is to come and speak at graduation ceremonies, because I'm speaking to the next generation. And I am very pleased and honored that this is the first time as a member of parliament that I am speaking at a graduation class. And I'm so pleased that it's for the graduates of the Ottawa Islamic School. So congratulations. For the young people that are here today, you are embarking on your lives. you are now at the point where you're going on to further studies, you're thinking about your careers, some of you will enter the workforce, some of you will follow your passions. And one of the things that I think is exceptionally important and what I'd like to talk to you about today is something that your principal, Principal Mohammed Ahmed, talked about, and that is civic engagement. It's volunteering. It's contributing something to the larger society. And I think as you go forward in your careers, whether it is as a teacher, as a healer, as a scientist, whether you do like me, you go and work for the United Nations and help people in other parts of the world that don't have as much as we do, or you go into politics to help the people right here who need to be more equal, where we can build a world where everybody is counted, where everybody is included. This is your world now. This is your chance and your opportunity to help to build that community and build that society. And it is very, very important as you go forward to think about what you can contribute and not just what you can get from your career and from your futures. And every person has something special to contribute. Every person has something beautiful. And I know that those of you who are graduating today are already thinking about the types of things that you would like to do, the dreams that you have. And my main message to you today is never give up on those dreams. When I was young, I dreamed of working around the world for the United Nations. And when I was in my 20s, I got an opportunity to do an internship to go to Bosnia, which had just come out of a terrible war, and to help the people there for 6 months. And I hoped that those 6 months would lead to a job with the United Nations. And I tried and I tried, but after I finished my internship, it took me 6 years before I got another job with the United Nations overseas. And I never gave up. I researched, I applied, I even flew to Washington on my own dime to go to an interview for a job I didn't get, and I kept on trying and I kept on going. And after 6 years, I did get another job and I did start the career. And all those wonderful things that she said about me in my bio, with none of that would have happened if I had just stopped and given up. And then I went around the world and I was working with people, mostly with women in places in Africa and in Asia and other countries, where I felt I was really making a difference and really contributing and helping to make the world more equal, helping to close the gap between rich and poor and make sure that young people everywhere had opportunities. But I saw that my own country was becoming less equal. My own country was providing less opportunity for young people. There was more poverty right here in our own communities. And I found that my own country was moving down a road that was less inclusive and less democratic. And I made the decision that I needed to leave the job at the UN, which was what I had wanted my whole entire life. And I was finally living in New York, in Manhattan, traveling the world, 73 countries. And I quit my job at the UN because I wanted to run for Parliament in Canada. And I wanted to make a difference here. And guess what? I lost the election. So I'd given up my job, I had run for Parliament, I lost the election. What did I do? 4 more years I kept on building relationships in the community. 4 more years I kept on trying and kept on hearing from people. And I kept on going and I ran in the last election. And I won the last election, and now I'm a member of Parliament. So if I had given up, if I had stopped trying to get my dream job with the United Nations, if I had said, well, now I'm content, I have what I want in my life, and kept and not tried to come back home and make a difference, if I had lost the election and said, well, I'm going to give up, I'm not going to run again, I would not be here as your Member of Parliament, imparting words of wisdom to you. And so as you go forward, as you start your life with all of your dreams, just remember that anything is possible. If you are determined and if you believe in your values and you believe in yourself and you never ever give up and you're determined, you are going to be able to achieve everything that you want to achieve. Thank you.
It's been 13 years since the first group of Ottawa Islamic School graduates left the hallowed halls of our school to enter the wide world of post-secondary education. Now this year, we will have one of our past graduates here to share with you his experiences and to reflect on his time at Ottawa Islamic School. I would like to introduce our alumni speaker. Abdullahi Ahmed is currently working with the Ottawa Police Service, and he attended Ottawa Islamic School in grade 3.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. So before I start, I'd like to first congratulate all of our graduates here today. We're all extremely proud of you all. You know, you guys achieved a very important milestone in your lives, you know, obtaining the Ontario Secondary School Diploma. It's not an easy task, but now this is a new chapter in your lives that you've closed, and we're all extremely proud of you all today. Congrats. So just want to talk a little bit about why I'm here today. All right, I'm not just another police officer that's here to talk to you. You know, I sat exactly where you guys were sitting here. You know, I was a student at the Ottawa Islamic School since third grade. From grade 3 to grade 10, you know, I pioneered the first Ottawa Islamic High School that was opened through our doors and our walls at the Ottawa Islamic School. So I'm very proud of this achievement. I'm great to see this. I graduated 8th grade in the year 2000. So this is, what, 16 years now that we've put out of fresh faces and an amazing group of people here, and we're extremely proud of every one of you. So throughout my time at the Ottawa Islamic School, I'm sure that I drove some of my teachers bonkers, and I drove some of them crazy, especially Brother Jawid, who's been with me from the beginning. You know, I've been with Brother Ahmed Hashi here right from the third grade as well to now. And as you see, he's one of the faculty members of our school. So throughout the years when I was a member of the school as well, you know, people would be telling me, say, hey, you better watch what you do, because one day you're going to be a role model for the next set of group of people that come up here. You might be the new teacher. You know, I was told that you might be the next teacher that's standing in front of you, so you better be nice to your teachers, because what you do, your next students will do to you, all right? And these are things that I always took for granted, and alhamdulillah, look at me here today, going from sitting over there to standing over here and talking to the future of our city of Ottawa and the future of Canada and the future members of, you know, our astounded careers that we hope each and every one of you fill. You know, I've never always wanted to be a police officer. It's always something that was in my head. But when I was in taking career studies, you know, our faculty, our students and our teachers, we all got together and said, okay, how can we bring these new careers to our front line? Because as always, you know, our Somali parents and everybody wants you to be the engineer. Everybody wants you to be a doctor. But you know, math was never my strongest suit. I'm sure Brother Jawid can tell you guys that. But you know, it's definitely a thought that came in my head. You know, we had an Ottawa police officer come and meet us at the Islamic School, and he spoke to us in great lengths about policing and the importance of what that does in our community. And at the time, you know, that rang in my head. It was definitely planted. You know, that seed was planted, and that's all it took. I spoke to my parents about it, and at first they weren't really too supportive, right? They said, well, you should be a doctor. You know, go be the engineer, and, you know, it just wasn't my forte. So I decided to go into Algonquin College to take business administrative and took marketing to at least explore that option. It wasn't my thing. You know, I was always afraid of public speaking and talking and putting my face out there. So I decided, you know what, the program wasn't for me, but I tried to do as best as I could. And I decided to go into the workforce and see what opportunities there are in the workforce right outside of high school. And you know what, to tell you, it was very difficult. Alhamdulillah, I landed a job at TD Bank, and as a TD Bank rep, you know, making 10 bucks an hour, doing customer service, I was there 8 years, and I moved up the ladders to become a marketing manager. The marketing program I hated, right? So I became the marketing manager for East District Region at TD Bank Financial Group. Once I did that, you know, I decided, you know what, business might be for me. You know, I was probably crazy at Algonquin, but let's see if this is something for me. But every time I would show up to those board meetings and sitting in those offices working the Monday to Friday 9-to-5 gig, you know, in the back of my head I was saying, I really don't want to do this, right? You know, some people will talk you out of it and say, you should do your business, you know, this is what your family does, this is what, you know, what everybody in your community wants you to do, but really you know yourself best. So at the age of 24, I decided to go back to Algonquin College and took Police Foundations. And once I took the Police Foundations program, I was in a classroom with 18 and 19 year olds. No offense, guys, but as a as an older guy, this is it really sinks into you, right? So I took the program, and alhamdulillah, I met a lot of new connections. I met the chief of police at the time, Vern White, who's now a senator with the country. And I decided, you know, this is my option. This is my forte. And this is when it gets interesting. So I did the... So I did all my testing and whatnot to become a police officer, right? So they put you through a bunch of math and English and fitness testing. Alhamdulillah, the fitness testing, no problem. Math, remember, it's not my greatest forte, right? So what did I do? I reached out to the people that I knew. I reached out to my family, and my family are the people of the Ottawa Islamic School. I contacted Brother Jawid after many years of leaving Islamic School, and I sat with him for hours on end, and he helped me understand the algebra that I did 10 plus years ago that I didn't care about. All right, so he sat with me, he explained everything to me, alhamdulillah, I passed my testing and put in my applications and successfully got on to the career. I'm extremely proud to be representing the Muslim community of the city of Ottawa, the Somali community of the city of Ottawa. I'm one of the few Somali officers that are able to give back to our community, right? So every day that I come in uniform, every day that I speak with members of our community, you know, I'm showing them this is a foundation that was built of years and years of hard work put through by our parents, our families, our members of the Ottawa Islamic School, and our family members as well. So always, you know, just I don't want to take too much of your time, but I'll end on this note here. Just remember, you know, many people will tell you what you should be doing in life. You know yourself best, right? You know exactly what you want to do in your future. And the one question you should always ask yourself is, this program I'm doing and this career I'm going into, can I see myself doing this for the next 30 years, right? If that answer is yes, and you're very happy in where you are, then alhamdulillah, you're doing the right thing, and put your 110% in on that. You know, in the Islamic school, I was taught certain morals and values, right? And those morals and values were built on honesty and integrity. They're built on self-confidence, built on courage and strength. These are all foundations of Islam. All right, so I got that from Islamic studies and our Arabic classes and our astound faculty members and parents. And conveniently, they're the same values and characters that's required to be a police officer in our great country of Canada. So our great brothers and sisters, best of luck in your futures. You know, I wish you the very best, and remember, one day you'll be up here as well, giving your talk to the future members, and you know, I wish you all the best in your futures.
Jazakallah khair, Constable Abdullahi Ahmed. Our next speaker is a recent graduate from law school. His name is Abdulaziz Ahmed. Abdulaziz holds a double major degree in English literature and legal studies from Carleton University. He then went to Toronto to pursue a law degree at the Osgoode Hall Law School. He received his Juris degree this April. In August, he will take up a position as a corporate lawyer in Washington, D.C., where he will also attend the Georgetown University Law Center.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين يا ربنا لك الحمد كما ينبغي لجلال وجهك وعظيم سلطانك والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته I'd like to first start off by just mentioning how honored I am to speak to you, the class of 2016. And we have a special bond because I'm also from the class of 2016. So we are, I think, a special class. What I've been asked to impart to you is what it really means to understand to be civically engaged, and also how to work with each other in order to become better people as you move through your education in whatever path that you go to. And I remember my path into civic engagement or working with people or volunteering or helping out, at first had an ulterior motive. I was doing it for myself, because when I was going off to apply to law school, you needed, you know, resumes and pages filled with volunteering, community service, and these sort of things. But as you delve into these things, you actually start to see that there's a lot of people less fortunate than you. And there's a lot of people who your skills, be it, you know, speaking, be it writing, being advocating, be it, you know, helping out, being tutoring, whatever you can do, has a profound impact on their lives. And I remember one of the first clients that I had at the Downtown Legal Services at the University of Toronto was a lady who was having issues with her landlord. And so she came in, I got the file, and what she was going through was incredible. She had a hole in her wall, and then squirrels had gone into the hole in the wall. And what happened after was when she told her landlord, all he did was plaster the wall off. So he didn't remove the squirrels, he didn't deal with it, just plastered the wall off, and told her, you know, that's all I'm gonna do for you. If you want me to do any more, you know, you have to pay for it, you have to get a professional, all these sort of things. And when she came to us at the place, she had hit rock bottom, she had nothing, and she said, can you guys help me out? And so my whole life, or at least the last 3 years, all I'd been trained in was this sort of thing, helping out, advocacy, reading through contracts, and seeing what you can do for these people. And so what I say to you is that getting involved, all of you, be it 18, 19, because I know high school, for me, wasn't the best time of my life. I know, and in yearbooks, they used to write high school, the best 4 years of your life. For me, it was the furthest thing from the best 4 years of my life. But what it can do is define you into what you want to become. And I remember being in high school, and I think the constable spoke about this, and I was in... I remember one semester I took, you know, world civilizations and, you know, history and a bunch of these artsy kind of courses. And my mom came to the guidance council office and she was like, you know, what is this world history you're taking? You know, what is this civilizations class you're taking? You know, you need to replace it with chemistry and physics. And I said, no way. And the guidance counselor was like, oh, you know, if your mom says, you know, you gotta replace it with chemistry and physics, you know, you gotta have to kind of talk to her about it, see what happens. But in the end of the day, my mom and I, we rationalized it, and she kind of saw that I had different areas of strength. And one thing I wanna tell you guys as a side note is that all of us stand on the shoulders of giants who are our parents. And I know 100% every single thing that I've done in my life, my mother and father have been behind me 100%. I know that right now I'm 25. I was in Toronto last year in school, and my mom would still call me. Did you eat breakfast? You know, what do you have for groceries? Do you need money? And these sort of things. And likewise, my father would too. Follow up with me, come visit me, bring me places. Anything that I needed, they would be number one there to assist me, even if it putting what they wanted behind them. And so I know the Prophet, peace be upon him, once said, you know, مَن لَا يَشْكُرُ النَّاسِ لَا يَشْكُرُ اللَّهِ. Whoever has no thank or gratitude towards the people that assisted him, is not really thankful to God. And so we thank our parents, we thank our luminaries, we thank our mentors, many who I see today, my own mentors, for assisting us in where we got into today. The final thing that I want to touch on, because I don't want to, you know, overstay my welcome, is this idea of a couple skills that you need to take with you. The number one thing is humility. And I've learned it hard sometimes, that no matter where you get to, or what school you go to, or whatever program you get into, or whatever accomplishment that you get, it's worthy being humble about it in order to pursue something else. And so I say that because I had a friend one time who, you know, he got the top grade in the class, the highest GPA in the course in our year, and he was very almost braggadocious about it. Very, you know, in your face. I remember it. He was going around with everyone. Check this out, man. See this mark here? Like, look what I got. Top mark here. And what happened was the next year, next semester, and I kid you not, this high place he'd had went all the way to the, you know, bottom middle of the class. And this isn't to say don't be proud of your accomplishments. Because even in the Quran, we're told that when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brings them back, gives them their book, they go around and they show people and they brag about it and they tell people about it. But understand that your achievements are a blessing. And because you've had this blessing, it's incumbent on you to give back to other people who may be in a similar situation as you or people who need mentoring. You guys all have skills. Some of you are good in math. Some of you are good in English. Some of you are good in writing. Find people who are young people to assist them and mentor them and give them tutoring. Because I know the school that I went to elementary school in, and I kid you not, when I went to, it was a school called Christie Public School. It doesn't exist here anymore. But at Christie Public School, we had, you know, subpar equipment. We had, you know, for when we were playing soccer, we used to use two trees that weren't even next to each other. So one guy would say that one in, it didn't go in because it didn't cross one side of the trees. Our basketball nets were posted on the wall of the school. We didn't have nets. And so it was almost a very, very impoverished school. But what we had were teachers, and I never forget one of them because he even came to my own law school graduation, Mr. Bradley Bear. And what Mr. Bear taught us was that no matter where you are, this doesn't define you. And you as a person, if you move yourself out of high school, if you get out of middle school, if you go to university, then you need to go back to where you started. To wherever your story came to a start, you need to return to there and give back to someone else so that their story can reach someone else. And so they can go back and help someone else so that their story can come back. It's a circular process. All of us, our successes are intertwined. And anything that I get, if where I'm from or the people that I grew up with, I become haughty and I turn away from them and I forget them, then that's not really success. So assist those who are from the same place as you. Assist those who are from a different place than you. Assist those who have skills that you need. Mentor someone. Find someone to mentor, even at a young age. There will be, and I tell you, I know 12-year-olds, 11-year-olds, 13-year-olds that I talk to who think high school graduation is an impossible, who see it as the pinnacle of achievement, where to some of us, that's just the start. So find those folks. Talk to them. Give your time. Because your time sometimes is greater than anything you can give someone. So congratulations for all your success. Find the best path. Be confident in your achievements. Be bold in what you desire. Think big. Dream big for what you want. But stick with your community. Give back to where you came from. And never, ever forget the sacrifices that your parents and others have made in assisting you. Congratulations. Wassalatu wassalamu ala rasulullah.
Jazakallah khair, Abdulaziz Ahmed. Our next speaker, Abdurrahman Hussein, is a former graduate at the Ottawa Islamic School. He is well known amongst the Ottawa community, especially by us youth. Abdurrahman Hussein completed his degree at Carleton University before moving to Medina to study at the Islamic University of Medina. Without further ado, please welcome a hometown favorite, Abdurrahman Hussein.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Sallallahu wa sallam wa baraka ala nabiyyina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Before I begin, I want to apologize. I'm just recovering from a bit of a cold, so please forgive me if it's difficult for you to understand me. Alhamdulillah, first and foremost, I want to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and I want to thank the Islamic School for giving me the opportunity to stand in front of you, particularly the graduates of 2016. It's a blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that I had the opportunity to actually teach you guys when you guys were in grade 9, the boys in particular, Islamic studies, and I was your gym teacher in grade 8. But I'm not standing here in front of you as a teacher. But I appear in front of you as someone who sat in the seat that you were sitting in 9 years ago. It sounds really bad when I say that. 9 years, I really don't feel like it's been 9 years. But time is really flying. The first thing that's been really running through my head as I walked in and I sat, and I saw Constable Abdullah Abdi stand here and speak, is how, when I was in high school, I never thought standing today and seeing the scene today, I never thought in my wildest dreams that I would see what I'm seeing today when I was in high school. I never thought that I would be sitting here seeing Constable Abdullah Abdi, who at that time you knew as Abdullah Dere, right, in high school, or right, standing in front of us as a police officer. I never thought at that time in my wildest dreams that Ahmed Hashi, who at that time was a student as well in Abdullah's class, is sitting here as a teacher. I never thought in my wildest dreams that I'll actually come back to Islamic school and work and teach and be involved with you guys. I never thought at that time in my wildest dreams that I'll be where I am today, finished, graduate from university and getting married and having a family and living in the city of the Messenger of Allah. I never thought at that time that I would be in the position that I'm in today. And first and foremost, we have to remember that it is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that blesses us with all the blessings that we have. And that it is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that puts us in these positions that we're in from His wisdom subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I want to let you know, the first thing that I want to inform you is, do not limit your goals and your aspirations. You're sitting here right now, you spend the last 4 years in that school that we know. You just never know 9 years from now where you'll be and where your classmates will be and those major things that you'll achieve in your lives after you finish university and start your families and, you know, become millionaires or whatever you achieve or aspire to become. When you reach that point, you will not, at this point, you don't see it, but trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and work hard towards it. And this is an advice that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam informed us. The Prophet, peace be upon him, tells us, alayhi salatu wa sallam, ihris ala ma yanfa'uka wasta'in billah. Strive and work hard towards those things that are beneficial to you and seek the assistance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wala ta'jiz, and do not feel despair. Don't get lazy. Don't lose hope. Go forth. This is an advice given to all of us 1400 years ago by our Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And subhanallah, he continues on and says something really amazing, and this is really befitting of us in your situation today. He says sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and if you are afflicted with an affliction, do not regret, but put your trust in Allah, say this is the permission and the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and move on forward. You go to university, you fail a class. Don't lose hope. It's the qadr of Allah. It happened. It was by the permission of Allah that this occurred. Keep on moving. Throughout life, you will stumble and you will fall. But you got to get up and you got to keep on moving. So my first piece of advice to myself and to you is, as you move on from this noble step of graduating from high school and going to university, keep on going. You'll go through difficulties and hardships in life, but do not let it hold you back from achieving and reaching where you want to reach. That's number one. Number two, always be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with regards to what He gives you. Because everything that you do, the health that you have, the life that you're living, the good things that you're experiencing, it's all from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also, be grateful to those who have done good to you. Wallahi, you might not realize the hard work that your mothers and your fathers have put forth for you to reach where you are today. You know, as a former student, and especially, I didn't realize as a student, but I realized it when I was a parent, when I was a teacher in Islamic school, dealing with the parents and seeing how much they're really sacrificing for us, for their children, to achieve an education, to be successful, to reach the pinnacle and the point that you are at today, to move on to this next step. So be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for your parents and for those people who actually worked hard for you to reach where you are today. Also be grateful to your teachers and your staff in the school, because I know as a teacher, former teacher, right, the effort that they have to do for you day and night, you know. And wallahi, I'll be very honest with you, and this is my own opinion, the reason why teachers last in Islamic school and the reason why I enjoyed, I'm not, from all the jobs I had, Islamic school was my favorite. I can say that with no doubt. Why? Because you, as the students, really motivated me to come back every day. You know? It is you, the students, that motivate Brother Jawed to be here for all these years. I'm not trying to make him sound old, but when he came to Islamic school, I was in grade 7. And he's still here. Brother Hamanur is still here. The principal is still here. The principal became the principal when I was in grade 7. They've been here, and it's because of the whole environment of the school that people keep on coming back. And wallahi, if it was not for the fact that I was in Medina and had things to do, I would still be in the school. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to allow us to continue to be grateful and to be involved with the school. So in any way you can, I'm not asking you to all become teachers in OIS, okay? But what I'm asking you is, in any way that is suitable for you, to give back to the school. And whatever you aspire and you end up becoming, give back in whatever you can to the school. The last thing to conclude that I'm going to say is, you know, these graduations, there's a lot of speeches. People come here and give us reminders and give us talks. And I'll be very honest, when I was graduating from Islamic school, we had a lot of speeches as well. And most of the speeches that occurred, I really don't remember them. I'll be very frank and honest. I don't remember them, but there was one speech that I never forgot. And this speech was by Sheikh Ismail. Sheikh Ismail was our Islamic studies teacher at that time. And he gave a speech. I don't remember the whole speech, but I remember one thing in particular. He read some ayat from the Quran, and we all know the voice of Sheikh Ismail, hafidhahullah. And he read some ayat. I never forgot the ayat till today. And I never understood why he read the ayat until years later, when I understood the ayat and what they meant, and his analogy that he was using that day made sense. And it is for that reason that I remember it till today. So I want to relay to you that analogy that the Sheikh gave that day. He read some ayat from Surah Al-Inshiqaq. The ayat that I'm not going to read the ayat because I really don't have time, but I'm just going to briefly explain it. Those verses in that chapter of the Quran was talking about the scene that will take place on the Day of Judgment. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is describing to us the believer and how he has worked hard throughout his life, and now he's at the point where he's receiving the book in his right hand, and the emotions he's going through, and how he turns back to his people and he's happy and he's excited for the hard work that he has done while he was in this life. And the scenario of the other person whom did not fulfill his responsibilities towards his religion and towards Allah, and how he will receive the book in his left hand, and how he will not want to receive the book, and how he is going to be miserable. This is our ayat in Surah Al-Inshiqaq, right? A chapter of the Quran. And the Shaykh was trying to give us an analogy to make us understand that, hey, you spend the last 4 years in school working hard to achieve the success that you have today. This happy moment that you're feeling right now of finishing high school and celebrating, and all these people that are here for you, and you're going back to your families and you're excited and you're happy for getting your degree and finishing this hard-earned accomplishment, it all came, that success came through your hard work. And similarly, in the life that we live in, it is required from us to work hard throughout our lives until we leave this world and stand in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in order for us to also on that day attain success. At that time, it didn't make sense when the Shaykh recited those ayat, but it made sense to me now. And I want to just advise you to remember that as you continue in life and for as long as you live, remember your commitment and your responsibility towards Allah. And remember your commitment and your responsibility towards your family members, your mothers and your fathers and your community, and those who cared for you. Wallahi, this is the last point, I promise. When we went, after 2007, when I graduated, we went for Umrah. And Brother Muhammad was with us on that trip, the principal. And I remember when I went to Mecca, and I was in the Masjid, the Masjid al-Haram, I met some students from Somalia who were studying for some examinations in the University of Umm al-Qura in Mecca. They were studying in the Haram. And this was the first time I was exposed to, studying in an Islamic university. I mean, my father taught me at home, and I learned at home, but I had Sheikh Ismail and Sheikh Abdul Basit in the city at that time. But this was the first time I was exposed to the concept of studying in a university. And I remember they were studying for an exam in Arabic grammar. And I was amazed. And I remember going to Brother Muhammad and telling him, you know, when we go to Medina, I want to check out the Islamic University of Medina. And we actually went. The principal came with us. We went. At that time, to be honest, it was very disorganized. We went to the admissions office. They looked at me. They asked me if I have any papers. I just told them I finished high school right now and I came for Umrah. And they told me to get out of the office. And Brother Muhammad was with us. He can tell you the story. And from that time, I told myself, I need to get to this place. My first recommendation letters that I have were from Sheikh Abdul Rahman Hijazi and Sheikh Muhammad Rashad, rahimahullah ta'ala. He was the one who wrote for me the recommendation to go to Medina. And I kept on trying, but it didn't work out. Until last year, 2 years ago, Afwan, when I applied, actually went for an interview in the city. I went for Umrah with the grade 12s. Back in 2012, I did an interview. I didn't get accepted again, right? I came back, I still worked as a teacher. It was the last year, by Allah's permission, that a group from the university came to Islamic school. And I had no clue. I was working as a teacher with you guys in the school. I was written on my regular rotation for khutbah Jum'ah, the third Friday, I still remember. I came to do my khutbah as normal every month. And after the khutbah, the principal came up to me and some brother and said, this is the vice president of Islamic University of Medina who was here in your khutbah. I was in shock. He told me, come the next day, we're going to have an interview. I went, Brother Bashir, who was a teacher at Islamic school. We went, several of us went. The next year, we all got accepted. Bashir and I are over there now. The point that I'm trying to make is, The point is, this was, well, none of it was from me. None of it was, it was all Allah's plan. It was Allah's plan that I did not go to Islamic University of Medina in 2008 when I was with the principal, but rather allowed me to stay and to finish university and to work in the school and to get involved in my community. And what that resulted in was me going to Islamic University of Medina and having an appreciation for what I'm studying, because now I understand where I came from and what my community requires from me. As that time, I would have known, Allah only knows, maybe I would have went, but I would not have any direction in particular. So the point that I'm trying to make is, as I made in the beginning, trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You just never know, by you trusting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and working hard, where things will end up. So please forgive me for taking too long. 2016 graduates, congratulations, this is your day. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless you. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give you success in your upcoming endeavors and all that you achieve. And I know for a fact from you guys, the guys that I know, that you guys will reach high places. In grade 9, you guys had high aspirations. I've been away from you for 3 years, but I'm assuming you guys are at the level or even more than you were 3 years ago. Jazakumullahu khairan. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Thank you very much for your words, Brother Abdurrahman Hussain. To develop active contributing Canadian citizens and to give back to the community are the core objectives of Ottawa Islamic School. Our next guest is an example of how to be such a citizen. This year, we are privileged and honored to have amongst us Imam Sikandar Hashmi. Imam Sikandar grew up in Montreal, and most of his youth was spent at Al Rashid Islamic Institute in Cornwall, Ontario. Imam Sikandar has a bachelor's in journalism from Concordia University and graduated with distinction.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Wa salatu wa salamu ala ashraf al-anbiya'i wal-mursaleen. Sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Wa man tabi'ahum bi ihsan ila yawmiddin. Amma ba'd. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. I was having so much fun sitting in my seat and being inspired by all the speakers. I actually didn't feel like coming up and speaking. I was really having a great time, alhamdulillah. It's such an honor to be here, and I'm always thrilled to be around young people. And that comes from the realization that I had in a journalism class when I was studying in university. And I forgot what class it was, but it just dawned upon me one day that my fellow students that I was sitting with, that one day they were going to be, you know, news reporters, editors, active members of the media who I'm going to watch on television and I'm going to read their articles online and in newspapers. And you know, it didn't take long for that to happen. And now I have friends and colleagues, you know, across the country who are working in the media. So when I'm around young people, And mashallah, I see the graduating class of 2016. I know that I'm looking at tomorrow's leaders. And from amongst this group, we will have, you know, different types of leaders. We'll have, of course, the doctors and the engineers. But inshallah, we also have lawyers, future members of parliament, not to replace Anita, of course, but in the future. And perhaps a future prime minister, and any other type of leader that you can think of. Because everything is possible. And you know, I think fondly of one of my hadith teachers. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala preserve him. And during the lesson, he would just go off on tangents. And I loved it when he did that because, you know, we would stop studying and, you know, we would just listen. And it was just so inspiring. And he would just be like, you know, who's, and there's only a few of us. And he would just be like, you know, who's going to rise? Which one of you is it going to be? Who's going to revive the deen? You know, who's going to spread the message? Who's going to fix the problems, you know, that we're facing? Who's going to go out and change the world? And it was just, you know, he's a simple man with a simple message, but it was just so inspiring to listen to. And it always reminded me that I had a responsibility upon my shoulders. We all do. Every single one of us has this responsibility and this duty to give back and to do something, make an effort, because you see, the effort is what counts. The results are in the hands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We cannot control the results, but we can certainly control the effort and make the effort that goes into trying to bring about positive change. So today, I know we've been hearing a lot of speeches, and mashallah, they've been very, very inspiring. I just have maybe a couple of things I just want to point out. First of all, is really to value and cherish the blessings that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us. And in particular, our country. This country that we are in is our country. I'm passionately Muslim, and I'm also passionately Canadian. We are so blessed. We are so blessed, wallahi, to have the opportunity to live in this country where I am allowed to dress the way I want to dress, where I am allowed to speak and give khutbahs without having to go through censors, where I am able to educate people about my religion, where I am able to participate fully regardless of where I come from, what I look like, what I dress like, and what I believe in. Really, this is a great blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's amazing when I think about it that I can fly like this. I can go through airport security like this without always having to go through secondary inspection, really. I can go to Parliament like this. I can go and speak to members of Parliament. I can go to the Senate and speak to senators like this. And no one doubts my convictions. Nobody doubts my Canadianness. This is a great blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If we don't value our blessings, Allah azza wa jal can take it away from us and can give it to someone else. So my first piece of advice is, please, for all of us actually, let us continue to appreciate and value this blessing that we have. And as it has been said by previous speakers, our deen teaches us, our religion teaches us, that we must thank people if you want to be thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So always be thankful for those, and towards those, who have made this possible. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who gives us the opportunity. But there's a lot of people, past leaders of this country, veterans, others who thought about these freedoms and who were okay with that idea and who actually worked really hard to promote that idea and make it a reality. So always, always be grateful towards them. Secondly, you see, mashallah, you're embarking on this journey of life. And it's a real journey. Sometimes I think back to when I was your age. I was like, oh my goodness, I can't believe I actually said that. or oh my goodness, I can't believe I actually did that, you know, that was so silly, or you know, I can't believe I was actually behaving in that way, right? So as we go through this journey of life, you know, we're always learning, and we're always coming to new realizations. But one thing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in the Quran is that this life is a test. الَّذِي خَلَقَ الْمَوْتَ وَالْحَيَاةَ لِيَبَلُوَكُمْ أَيُّكُمْ أَحْسَنُ عَمَلًا. Right? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us that He has created death and life so He can test us. And what is Allah Azza wa Jalla looking from us? What does He want from us? The best. أَيُّكُمْ أَحْسَنُ عَمَلًا. Not just what is good, but what is best. So in the course of this journey, you and all of us indeed are going to face many choices, many questions and many choices that we're going to have to make. So always aim for the best. Always try to make the best decision. Always try to say the best things. That's what the hadith tells us as well, right? Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam telling us that a true believer, right, is the one who speaks good or remains silent, right? So you always want to do that is best. So think before you do something. Always weigh your options. Consult with one another. Consult with the elders, and mashallah, you have some great role models, right? So consult with them, reach out to people, and always remember that the best is usually more difficult. Doing what is good and what is right, and indeed what is best, is not always easy. It's easy to divide people. It's easy to speak without thinking. It's easy to cause divisions. It's easy to move away from the guidance of Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But that's not the best thing to do. And what we really need in our communities, and I'm again so inspired to see you all, is we need leaders. We need leaders who are Canadian. We need leaders who understand our current circumstances. But we also need those leaders to be connected to our heritage. We also need these leaders to be guided by the values that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us and that His beloved Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has taught us. And again, that's not always easy. But if your heart remains connected with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if your mind is in the right place, then inshallah, you will be guided by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Inshallah, you will achieve amazing results. And again, the results are in Allah's hands. It's going to be through your effort and dedication. And the results are going to come from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Congratulations. I'm so happy to see you here today. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continue to bless you. May Allah azza wa jal bless your parents and your families. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make you the best future leaders that we can have. Jazakum Allahu khairan.
Next, I would like to call upon two representative students from the grade 12B classroom who would like to share a few words. First up, we have Abdurrahman Hirsi.
Assalamu alaikum. My name is Abdurrahman, and I'm going to be talking on behalf and representing the grade 12B class. First, I would like to thank the parents and teachers who have worked tirelessly day in and day out just to get us where we are here today. And secondly, I would like to congratulate my fellow classmates who made it this far. It's times like this where we reminisce about the more simpler times, where our daily lives consisted of random outdoor trips and Sister Anna's bake sales. But all these little things that we took for granted at the time, and I stand here thinking how I'll forever miss them when they're no longer the norm. When the year first started, I was really excited. But don't get me wrong, I'm still super excited, but now it's more of a bittersweet feeling. The school was our comfort, and after spending 8 long years here, I am ready, but also very anxious, and I'm sure we all feel the same way. There are things that I'll forever miss in OIS, like no more Sister Anu giving me reminders and acting as an extension of my mom, or no more Jawa's daily reminders, or no more Brother Hussein making jokes about Samatar, or no more Brother Hassan and his lesson objectives and his famous scarf. But like all good things in life, things must come to an end. And people don't really notice it, but OIS is like a family. And they've always been helping us behind the scenes, and wallahi, we should always thank them. We were extremely fortunate to have experienced this. And note to myself first, all the things that we've learned here, we should implement it and add it to our next phase of our lives. So I'll leave you with this. Whenever there comes a time where you lost yourself, take a look back to OIS and remember the memories you made there so you could find yourself again. And now I want to give a few shout outs. Shout out to Eunice. Yeah, I swear this guy forever, he's always helping me out, encouraging me and supporting me. Wallahi, people don't know, wallahi, he's an amazing friend. Shout out to Ar-Rahman Nur. This guy, he always has heart. Even if he has something important to do, he would always be helping me out. Shout out to Muhammad Umar. The reason why I love this guy is he doesn't care what other people think. He always does stuff because he wants to do it himself. And wallahi, his stories always make me laugh. Shout out to Elias. We first met each other by working at Walmart together. But little by little, when he came to OIS, I began to know him more, and wallahi, he's an amazing guy. Shout out to Ar-Rahman Muhammad. This guy is one of the few most genuine, humble, and honest people I ever met in my life. And wallahi, I make dua to Allah that I could be even a little bit like him. Shout out to Hamza and Hassan. How much people could say that they have twins in their class? Their personalities are so unique, and you honestly wouldn't think they're the twins. Wallah, it's a blessing to have people like them. Shout out to Muhammad Mustafa, forever reading Hunger Games at lunchtime. I swear, the faces he makes always makes me laugh. Shout out to Abar Kamikaze. I swear, Abar, amazing guy. Shout out to Samatar. Don't think I forgot about you. He's always cracking jokes in class. Shout out to Muhammad Dad. I sat in front of this guy for 3 straight years. Every day I'd be annoying him, ask him math questions, English questions, even Islam study questions. And he'd always help me out. He would never push me aside. Wallahi, he's a true friend. Shout out to Muhammad Mahmoud. This guy, I swear, is what you call true family. We've been together since diaper days. Wallahi, it's unimaginable how much I love this guy, and it's pretty embarrassing, but I catch myself looking up to him sometimes. And last but not least, I want to give shout out to my parents, especially my mom. The stuff that she does behind the scenes, people will not even imagine how crazy it is. And every day, I think to myself, a role model, I think to my mom, she's my inspiration, my motivation, everything like that. And I make... dua to Allah that I can have just an ounce of her characteristics. Because wallahi, this woman, she is a superwoman in my eyes, wallahi. And assalamu alaikum.
Thank you very much, Abdurrahman Hirsi. That was a very heartfelt speech. Up next, we have Samantar Muhammad. Please welcome Samantar to the stage.
Whew. Amazing speech, Abdurrahman. Assalamu alaikum. Honored guests, parents, students, teachers, and my fellow graduates, good morning. Now, I'm sure you're expecting a young, smart, charming individual like myself to give an amazing speech, and that's exactly what I'm going to do. First off, I wanted to thank everyone for coming to this once-in-a-lifetime event, this once-in-a-lifetime achievement that we may never experience again. When I was writing this speech, I honestly didn't know where to start. There were so many people, friends, family, teachers, that got me standing here today making this wonderful speech. So as valedictorian, I would like to express my appreciation to all of my teachers, friends, family, and everyone else who helped us get to where we are today. I would also like to thank the administration for providing me with this opportunity. So when I first came back to OIS, I remember I was nervous, shaking, walking up those steps, but I was also excited to start my high school here and see what's in store for my future at OIS. And throughout my time here at OIS, I've met so many special teachers, so many special people, my teachers and the administration, all with amazing personalities. You are all kind and welcoming, compassionate, upbeat, respectful, funny, highly talented people, and I was so lucky to have countless great memories with all of you. But this is something that is just a part of our school. It's also visible in the rest of the community as well. But seriously, aren't teachers the best? Just hearing Jawad constantly remind us every day after Salah, or meeting Brother Hassan every morning before you get to guest class, and having a nice long conversation with Sister Anab. Give them a round of applause. It's what they live for, and it's what brought us here today. My classmates, you are all amazing people, and I couldn't have spent my time with anyone else. You guys are the best of the best. Your vast talents range from performing arts, to athletics, to various fields of academic study. For proof, look no further than this year's OFSA tournament champions. As Abu Tahir and Mu'adh bin Jabal, may Allah be pleased with them, reported that the Prophet ﷺ said, "Fear Allah wherever you are, and follow the vicious deed with a good one, which will obliterate it and deal with people with good manners." We have been given rich opportunities in a safe and happy environment. And for that reason, I believe that we can overcome any obstacle that comes our way. They say that life is short and that you have to work for everything in order to succeed. Well, it's true. Life is too short for Twitter beef or basketball games. It's too short to spend all day playing Destiny and 2K. You guys know that you're smarter than that. In high school, you had your ups and downs, your good days and bad days, but you have to get past that. You have to get over it. You have to be productive and contribute to this wonderful community that we're all a part of, and sacrifice and spend our time accomplishing great things and have a great impact in the world and in our community. It is time to set your goals for your future. However, before you can do that, you need a vision. You need a dream. Over the next few years, you may end up at college or university. You may even begin working. No matter what your dream is for the future, you can get there with a dedication, determination, focus, and skills that you have learned here at this very school. We, the class of 2016, are a powerhouse of innovation and creativity. We will push the boundaries to make this world a better place in big ways, small ways, sideways, and in our own way. But before I leave, I want to give out some shout-outs. I want to give a shout-out to my Hoya, greatest woman alive. I would not be here today without you, Hoya. I'm shaking so much. I couldn't have been here without my Hoya and my Abba paying everything for me. This nice suit that I'm wearing, it wouldn't be here on my chest without my parents. And I want all you guys to turn around and look at your parents, because you wouldn't be here today without them. And I want to give shout-out to the teachers and the administration working day in, day out, after hours, before hours, staying in school and looking and working for you. And I want to give shout out to the caretakers of this school. I cannot imagine anyone else doing a better job than you guys. Always remember Allah and always remember where you came from. Congratulations, graduates, and thank you, everyone.
Thank you very much for that, Samathar. Now, two sisters from the graduating class, Aya Qadri and Halima Noor, would like to present a poem that they've written. So I'd like to welcome them to the stage now.
So, assalamu alaikum. As Halima said, we had very different ideas, so I apologize, but I'm gonna bore you all with my seriousness. Okay. So, what once was the present is now the past. What's left behind us is the shadow that we cast. Ahead of us is the glare of our future, captivating with the uncertainty of this venture. What once was a future is now the present, daring us to experience what we haven't. Armored with a brimming world of knowledge, curiosity feeding our sense of courage. Braced with the memories of our troubles, through learned experiences we face our battles. Defeating the possibility of failure, rising victorious as a warrior. Those we have met and what we have learned reflect on the mountains that shall be overturned. Through our will and through our power, we will leave no question without an answer. Participating in the race of time, facing the peaks that we will climb. Outrageous blunders we will make, countless opportunities we will forsake. Through this process we will be changed, for the better our qualities will be exchanged. Questions will become answers. Through them, we will finally set down our anchors. Thank you.
Well, me and I had different ideas of what the graduation poem should be about. So we actually wrote two different poems because there's just so much we had to write. And I apologize if you don't find my jokes really funny, Jawed or Toma. It's been a long time. We've been on such a journey. 14 years of school and a lifetime of memories. No matter where we end up, I'll never forget the moments in time together we spent. It makes me sad, but this isn't the ending. Life for us is just beginning. Full of cliches, I know it's true, but for us, life will begin anew. Some things from here I will not miss, like Toma's blogs and Jawed's quiz. No more sneaking out for lunch, and no more uniform, just a hunch. All jokes aside, here's the truth. There's just three words today that suit. Today's a celebration, a farewell, and a beginning, and above all else leaves our parents grinning. We worked for many long, hard years, so celebrate the special days here. For 14 years, we did our best. Witness all the knowledge we possess. Say farewell to OIS. With great happiness, we all progress to wherever our life leads us next. This beginning, new goals we will set. For now, rejoice in our accomplishments. Of course, remember to reach for the stars, because everyone, the future is ours. I'd also like to give a quick shout out to my parents. Peace.
Thank you very much to all of our representatives for speaking. This year's valedictorian has been attending Ottawa Islamic School since grade junior kindergarten. She set goals for herself as a child and worked tirelessly to achieve those goals. She strives in excellence in all that she does. She is a student known for her hard work and humility. She is kind, respectful, and always ready with a polite salam. Her ambition, drive, and focus to learn have propelled her to exceptional academic achievement. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the valedictorian of 2016, Miski Daher.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Dear parents, teachers, administration, family, friends, and of course my fellow graduates, I'd like to welcome you all to this year's grade 12 graduation. We are having our graduation ceremony during the last 10 days of Ramadan. I'm not sure if you knew that, but it is a blessing from Allah, so alhamdulillah. Graduates, I want you all to reflect upon everything you've learned and gained from the first day you started school up until your final day today. Think of everything you've been blessed with and everything you've achieved. I'm sure you will find that throughout these long years, we've been blessed with so much. We've gained knowledge that will last us not just one, but two lifetimes, something we would never have gained anywhere else. We've learned how to read the Quran, the stories of the prophets, how to pray, while yet learning subjects like physics, calculus, English, and chemistry. We should be proud of these achievements, and today's a day to celebrate those achievements. However, it's important to realize that these achievements don't only belong to us. We would not have what we have today if it hadn't been for the strong support system that we've had. First of all, I'd like to thank our parents. Jazakallah khairan to all the parents. You've worked long hours, you've worked hard to ensure the success that we have today. You've encouraged us to study hard and become more successful than we could possibly imagine. Jazakallah khairan to all our parents, and no amount of thank yous will ever compensate for the sacrifices and hardships you've went through to raise us. Jazakallah khairan to the principal for his admirable character and for genuinely caring for the well-being of the students. Jazakallah khairan is also owed to our teachers. We've had teachers like Brother Hamidi, who showed us that by saying Allahumma salli ala Muhammad, we could get candy in this life and ajr in the next. Teachers like Brother Toma, who opened our eyes to the color pink. I no longer associate it with five-year-old girls. Rather, I associate it with LOLs on the margins of our assignments. I hope you enjoy the cliche I just dropped there. Teachers like Jawed, who taught us that math is life, or at least that's what she said. And teachers like Brother Ali Jama, who taught us a very important lesson, that a teacher is only a guide. Our teachers guide us to become more successful than the successful graduates that we are today. We've had teachers who have done more than any teacher should do to ensure that their students are comfortable and educated. They shared their times with us and explained concepts, sometimes repeatedly, to us. They've challenged us to think critically, and for that we are grateful. We've had an administration who has helped run the school and make it a suitable environment for us to learn in. In the hallway, we would have Sister Anna, who does so much behind the scenes that we are unaware of, and she also advised us to become better Muslims. In the hallway, when we walked into the school, we were always greeted with smiles and salams, and our school has been a positive environment that has contributed to the achievements that we have today. We should also thank each other. We've been together for a very long time, and throughout the years, we've become more than just classmates or friends. We've become sisters and brothers in Islam. We've helped each other grow as people and academically. And I will forever be grateful for those 3M group chats with solutions and explanations to challenging topics and questions. And if I were to give out a shout out to all of you, I'd be here for an eternity, because no amount of words could ever compensate for the feelings that I have for you in my heart. May Allah bless you all. To my fellow graduates, I'm not really in any position to be sharing words of wisdom, so instead, I will share words of wisdom from the wisest amongst all of us, the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Ibn Abbas narrated that Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, "Take advantage of five before five, your youth before your old age, your health before your illness, your riches before your poverty, your leisure before your work, and your life before your death." We are all young, mostly healthy. We have a lot of free time on our hands, and we are not in poverty. Almost all of these five categories apply to us. So my fellow graduates, take advantage of them. We are all graduating with the ingredients to success, and the principles we've learned over the years will be our guiding light for the years to come. Use everything you've got and channel that into success, whatever your definition of success may be. We can't predict the future, but whatever we do, we can make sure to push beyond the limits. As we grow older, so do our responsibilities, and our accomplishments contribute to the accomplishments of the community. Become leaders of our community. Make an impact. Be sincere in everything you do. Be true to yourself. And as fellow graduate Aya Kadri ingeniously once said, it's up to us to convert all that potential into kinetic energy and create some motion in the world. And with that, I'd like to say congrats to this year's class of 2016. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Jazakallah khairan, Miski. We've now come to the diplomas and awards presentation, and we'll begin with the distribution of the Ontario Secondary School diplomas along with the Ontario Scholar Medals. The Ontario Scholar Medal is awarded to students who achieve an average of 80% or higher in their top 6 grade 12 courses. And I'd like to call upon our principal, our guidance counselor, together with Brother Ahmed Hashi, to present the diplomas and the medals.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Now we come to the most important part of our event today, our graduating students receiving their diplomas. I'll be calling up each student inshallah, and I'll also be mentioning where they will be going after graduating from Ottawa Islamic School, what program and career they will be pursuing, inshallah. So I'd like to first and foremost begin with Sister Khadija Abdi. Sister Khadija is an Ontario scholar, and she has received the subject awards in advanced functions, international business, and writer's craft. She will be going to Carleton University, inshallah, pursuing a degree in commerce with a specialization in entrepreneurship. She has also received an entrance scholarship. Next, I'd like to call Brother Mohamud Abdi. Brother Mohamud is an Ontario scholar. He has received the subject award in Islamic studies. He will also be going to Carleton University pursuing a bachelor's in economics. Next, I'd like to call up Brother Yusuf Abdullahi.
Yusuf will be pursuing a degree in IT from Algonquin College, inshallah. Next, I'd like to call up Hanan Adam. Hanan is an Ontario scholar. She has received the Subject Award in Canadian and World Politics. She will be pursuing a nursing degree from both Ottawa University and Algonquin College. She has also received an entrance scholarship. Next, I'd like to call up Awo Ahmed. Awo is an Ontario scholar. She has received the subject awards in Canadian and International Law and Food and Nutrition. She'll be traveling and taking some time off, visiting Djibouti, inshallah. Next, I'd like to call up Brother Omar Ahmed. Omar will be pursuing a degree in computer engineering and technology from Algonquin College, inshallah. Next, I'd like to call up Yasmin Ahmed. Yasmin is an Ontario scholar. She has received the subject awards in advanced functions, food and nutrition, calculus, and writer's craft. She will be pursuing a degree in biology from the University of Ottawa. And she has also received an entrance scholarship. Next, I'd like to call up Brother Hassan Ali Raiga. Hassan is an Ontario scholar. He received the subject awards in computers, chemistry, Islamic studies. He will be going to Carleton University pursuing a degree in computer science, inshallah. Next, I have Aisha Asad. Aisha Asad is also an Ontario scholar. She has received the subject awards in advanced functions, writer's craft, calculus, and in chemistry. She'll be pursuing a degree in neuroscience and mental health at Carleton University with an entrance scholarship. Next, I'd like to call up Brother Muhammad Dad. Muhammad has received, or is an Ontario scholar, and has received the subject awards in advanced functions, English, chemistry, and Islamic studies. He will be pursuing a degree in software engineering from Carleton University with an entrance scholarship. Next, I have Miski Dahir. Miski is an Ontario scholar, and she has received the subject awards in advanced functions, English, Islamic studies, physics, biology, calculus, and international business. She will be pursuing a degree in neuroscience from Carleton University with an entrance scholarship as well. Next, I have Sara Al-Abd. Sara will be taking some time to decide what she will be pursuing in the future, inshallah. Next, we have Sister Yusra Hamouda. Yusra has received the subject award in functions. She'll be pursuing chemical engineering degree at University of Ottawa with an entrance scholarship. Next, but unfortunately not with us today, is Fatima Hashi. Fatima is an Ontario scholar. She has received an award in advanced functions, English, Islamic studies, calculus, international business. She will be pursuing a degree in software engineering from Carleton University with an entrance scholarship. I should say that, she's my sister, so. Next we have Adna Hirsi. Adna is an Ontario scholar. She has received the subject award in Canadian World Politics, and she'll be going to Carleton University pursuing a degree in child studies. Next we have Abdurrahman Hirsi. Abdul Rahman is an Ontario scholar who has received the subject awards in advanced functions, biology, calculus, English, Islamic studies, and in international business. He will be going to Ottawa University, pursuing a degree in nursing with an entrance scholarship, inshallah. Next, we have Sister Rabia Islam. Rabia is an Ontario scholar. She has received the subject awards for international business, Canadian international law, food and nutrition, and for writer's craft. She'll be going to Carleton University, pursuing a degree in communication and information technology. Next, we have Sister Aya Kadri. Aya is also an Ontario scholar. She has received the subject awards in advanced functions, calculus, biology, English, Islamic studies, physics, and in writer's craft. She'll be going to Carleton University with an entrance scholarship, pursuing a degree in chemistry. Next, we have Abrar Kazi. Abrar is an Ontario scholar, and he has received the subject awards for computer science, physics, international business, calculus, Canadian and world politics, advanced functions, English, chemistry, and Islamic studies. He will be going to Carleton University, pursuing a degree in computer science and math. He has also received an entrance scholarship. Next, I have Abu Ubaida Muallim Ishaq. Abu Ubaida will be going to Carleton University, pursuing a degree in computer science. Next, I have Abdul Rahman Muhammad. Abdul Rahman is an Ontario scholar. He has received the subject awards in English and Islamic studies, and he'll be taking some time off to travel to Egypt this year, inshallah. Next, we have Sister Halima Muhammad. Sister Halima will also be taking some time to travel this year, inshallah. Next, we have Mona Muhammad. Mona will be going to Algonquin College, pursuing a degree in dental hygiene, inshallah. Next, we have Brother Samatar Muhammad. Samatar, our self-proclaimed handsome one, is also an Ontario scholar. He has received subject awards in business, computers, and Islamic studies. He will be going to Carleton University, pursuing a degree in biomedical sciences. Next, we have Souda Muhammad. Souda is also an Ontario scholar, and she will be going to Ottawa University, pursuing a program in second language teaching, ESL, inshallah. Up next, we have Muhammad Mahmoud, who is also an Ontario scholar. Muhammad has received the subject awards in food and nutrition, international business, advanced functions, and Islamic studies. He will be going to Ottawa University with an entrance scholarship, pursuing health sciences. Next, we have Yunus Musa. Yunus will be going to Algonquin College, inshallah. He will be pursuing a degree in construction engineering, technical and civil engineering technology. Next, we have Liban Musa. Liban Musa is also an Ontario scholar, and he will be studying finance at Carleton University, inshallah.
Next, we have Muhammad Mustafa. Muhammad Mustafa is also an Ontario scholar. He has received the subject awards in computer science, advanced functions, international business, and in Islamic studies. He will be going to Carleton University with an entrance scholarship studying computer and internet security. Next, we have Brother Abdulrahman Noor. Abdulrahman is also an Ontario scholar. He has received the subject award in Islamic studies, and he will be pursuing a degree in computer science, inshallah. Next, we have Sister Halima Noor. Halima is also an Ontario scholar, and she will be going to Carleton University with an entrance scholarship studying commerce, inshallah. Next.
Love is everywhere. So much peace fills up the air. Ramadan, month of the Quran. I feel it inside me, strengthen my iman.
Inshallah. Next we have Hamza Noor. Hamza will be pursuing a degree in the field of law in the future, inshallah. Up next, we have Hassan Noor. Hassan is an Ontario scholar, and he has received the subject awards in advanced functions, Canadian and international law. He will be going to the University of Ottawa studying economics and public policy. Next, we have Sister Hafsa Omar. Hafsa is an Ontario scholar. She has received the subject award in food and nutrition. She will be going to both the University of Ottawa and Algonquin pursuing a degree in nursing with an entrance scholarship. Next, we have Muhammad Omar. Muhammad is an Ontario scholar, and he has received the subject awards in advanced functions, international business, and in Islamic studies. He will be pursuing a degree in mechanical engineering at Carleton University. Next, we have Ilyas Osman. Ilyas is also an Ontario scholar. He has received the subject award in international business, and he will be going to Carleton University with an entrance scholarship studying software engineering. Next we have Sister Suad Osman. Suad will be pursuing a degree in developmental service worker at Algonquin College, inshallah. Next, we have Fahia Roble. Fahia is an Ontario scholar. He has received the subject awards in advanced functions, international business, food and nutrition, and Islamic studies. He will be going to Carleton University with entrance scholarship pursuing computer sciences. Up next, we have Abdulrahman Shukran Wafiq. Abdulrahman is also an Ontario scholar, and he has received the subject awards in advanced functions, physics, international business, biology, calculus, English, chemistry, and Islamic studies. He will be going to Carleton University studying neuroscience and mental health with an entrance scholarship, inshallah. Next, we have Brother Bilal Siad. Bilal will be going to Algonquin College pursuing a degree in mechanical engineering, inshallah. Okay. All right, so I made a mistake. I forgot to call our next graduating student, Jamila Hussein. Jamila is also an Ontario scholar, and she has received the subject awards in Islamic studies, advanced functions, biology, calculus, English, and international business. She will be pursuing a degree in nursing at the University of Ottawa with an entrance scholarship, inshallah. Next, we have Sister Fatima Wardera. Fatima is also an Ontario scholar, and she has received the subject awards in advanced functions and food and nutrition. She will be going to the University of Ottawa and Algonquin College, pursuing nursing with an entrance scholarship. Next, we have Aisha Warsame. Aisha is also an Ontario scholar. She has received the subject awards in advanced functions. She'll be going to Carleton University studying statistical and actuarial sciences with an entrance scholarship. Next, we have Sherwa Yusuf. Sherwa is also an Ontario scholar. He has received the subject awards in Islamic studies and in food and nutrition. He will be going to Carleton University, pursuing a degree in economics, inshallah. And that is the graduating class of 2016.
Next, I would like to call upon my coach, Didia, to present the sports awards.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. The three of us, as well as brother Mohammed Farah, who couldn't be here today, had the pleasure of coaching the Ottawa Islamic School basketball team this year. We competed against some of the best teams in the city, went toe-to-toe with them, and ended up winning the city championship in the A division. Where we then went to compete at Sault Ste. Marie and finished with the Consolation A Championship. The grade 12s this year that are graduating now helped us in the past 2 to 3 years compete on some of the biggest stages and against some of the best competition. And I would like to thank them, even though there's only three that played on the team this year. Had they been on any other team and been with any other players, they still would have contributed just as importantly. The first one I would like to award is the Coach's Award. The Coach's Award is similar to a Principal Award, and it goes to a player who has characteristics of all kinds that are very important to a team. Someone who works hard, someone who's there for their teammates, a leader, a smart student, and as well as a good student. The student and graduate and player that I would like to award this to, I've had the pleasure of coaching for 2 years now. He's not the biggest person, but I like to say he has the biggest heart. And he's someone that actually works really hard and is extremely important to the team. Without him, there would be no one to lead the team, and he's our point guard, Sherwa Yusuf. Sherwa, can you please come up? Yeah. The one thing I seem to tease Sherwa about sometimes is he doesn't seem to know. Sometimes he passes the ball to the other team a little too much. Now, it's a common fact that with any sports, you like to keep the ball away from your opponents. where Shirwa decided to give them the ball sometimes. Sometimes I would even have to tell them, call timeouts and tell them that, do you know who your teammates are? They're wearing the same jerseys as you. But Shirwa was definitely one of the most important people that I've met and coached in the past 2 years. And just one round of applause for him, please. Next is my favorite award, the Most Improved Award. Now, the Most Improved Award, by definition, goes to the person that has shown the biggest change, the biggest improvement. And usually, when it comes to sports, it comes to skill. But with this person, it also comes to character. It comes to maturity. He's shown a huge difference. I've coached him for the past 3 years. And the first 2 years were an experience. But this year, alhamdulillah, it was a great deal. He probably took the season the most serious out of everybody and was probably the biggest leader on the team. The first 2 years, I had to tell him a number of times, you know, make it to practice, let's go, let's show a little bit more dedication. But by this year, he was actually telling everybody, guys, let's go, we got to be at practice, we got to do. Even though he was still there late, he was there and he actually was the leader of the team and the captain of the team. And he has a good rate to show for the next award as well. And I could probably give him each and every one of these awards. Abu Ubaida Isaac. The last award is the Most Valuable Player Award, and it goes to, of course, the person that you would think played the best and scored the most points, usually on the sports team. But with this person, it's just not about the points and scored and how he played. This person actually worked the hardest on both ends of the court, and that's something that's not really rewarded enough. He played well on both sides. He actually was a leader as well. He's a good student. And I'm sure you guys, once I say his name, will understand why. He's a good overall person and a leader in the community as well as on his team. We have I'm going to quickly just tell you a quick story about this person. We have I do this thing with players on my teams where for every charge you get a Gatorade. And I'm probably no 80% of the people don't know here don't know what a charge is, but I'm gonna quickly try to explain as quickly as possible. It's when you kind of just get in front of, on defense, when you get in front of the offensive player and pretty much take a hit and fall down, pretty much in layman's terms. But it's something that's very hard, and it probably happens once in a game. And this person actually did it 3 to 5 times a game. And by the end of the season, I probably owed him over 150 Gatorades, and I'm still trying to pay him all the Gatorades. And I'm probably going to be giving him Gatorades his entire university career. But Fahey Roble, can you please come up, please? Thank you. These are your grade 12 graduate basketball team members and the three guys that I've been coaching for the past 2 years, as well as Brother Abdelaziz Toma, Brother Abdelaziz Mohammed, as well as Brother Mohammed Bara. And we're very proud of them in the way they've done academically as well as through sports. And the last thing I want to say is I just want to thank the members of the school, the staff, the principal, as well as the finance department. Brother Omar, I see you over there. Everybody has been very supportive of the team this year, and inshallah, next year, in the years to come, when we have a gym where we can play whole games, I hope to see all you guys there rooting us and watching me yell at the students and the players. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله ولي الصالحين وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين أن مانتا أو أن إلهي إنه قدري وفضلي سئيه من ندي سوي أنا إنه وحمد الله إنه 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 شوقني أن قال إن جبنتي صدحي طبنات أن أوتو إسلامي سكول أي كقال إن جبيان أرضي ذا sanadka ugu dambeeyay ee grade 12ka marka in maanta waxa in qalin jabiyay 34 ardaydii ah in midba sugeya in loo soo dhameeyo war u sugeyo oo aan credits-kiisa u baahna u dhameyn isaguna sidii kale hawlisa kale u dhameeyo u dhamaayeen laakiin mar hadii wixii aan xumba ka dhameeyeen waa graduation ku waa kanaya sidaas ah 34 kaasi maanta ku graduate garoobeen oo ku qaateen diplomahoodi shahaadi Secondary 22 waxay tageen jaamacada waxad jaamacada Ottawa xalay Carleton 9 waxay tageen jaamacada Ottawa U marka halka 13 kamid ah labada jaamacada ay tageen 8na college Algonquin College marka saddex ba iyagu raba jaamacadaha dibadaha inay tagaan oo sidaa darteed dib u dhigtay inay application kooda meel kale la eegtaan laga yaabo ama in Ontario jaamacad kale ama kuwa Canada laakiin inta badan reerooday ku dhawaadaan laba jaamacadna waa laba jaamacadood oo isbaray oo iyagu yimaada iskuulka sanado markuu bilaabmayo hadda ardayda ka baxday laba jaamacadood waxay la socdeen laga soo bilaabo September aan bay in ziyaradooda ugu horeeyay sameeyeen marka sidaas aan maanta arday baxday ay ahaayeen aan qaybaha ugu badnaa ee u baxay waxa kamid aha ay u socdeen arday maanta ka baxday aan engineering oo aha 9 sidaan qiyaasayo aan fields dhowro health sciences ka kooban oo ah aan health science ka caadiga aan biology chemistry biomedical science neurosciences inta soo isugu imanaysa science ka caadiga iyaguna waxay ahaayeen 13 and business iyo finance iyo commerce and ardayda qabatay la 4 bay ahaayeen and child studies iyo early childhood education labo sidaas ay qaybaha guud ahaan sanadka waxa quray ka maqna oo by chance sida u dhacday waxay ahayd waxyaabaha social sciences ka iyo arts ka oo aan maba kaba muuqan ba meesha laakiin sanadihii hore ama journalism ha noqoto ama ha noqoto in psychology ama ha noqoto sociology ama history iyo waxyaabaha la mid ah social development international
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. أرتا تور رسا حفلة دي مانتا عن كسو وضع غيب قلني وحا كسو وضع غيب قلني دادكي سكول كعروتو أيو ديگانيين أوتاوا إسلامي سكول سكول كو سيدي سبا مغالا دن أوتاوا كو يلا أرديد ديگتا أو نلا شمبغول غاريسا مانتا وحا فصل كالبيتوان عاد لمييي oo diploomka 12aad qaatay 54 arday ah 34 arday ah marka inta jaamacada tagtay iyo inta college ka tagtay walaalkeen maxamed principal ka ayaa ka waramay xafladan maanta si wanaagsan ayay noogu dhacday waxa ka soo qayb galay community leaders ka waxa ka soo qayb galay MP ga magaalada oo dhinaca westiga ee iskuulka ku yaalo waxa ka soo qayb galay imaamiyada iyo mujtamaaca muslimiinta ee ku nool magaalada Ottawa xafladdu waa xaflad qiiro ku gelinaysay marka aad fiiriso caruurtu sida ugu faraxsanayeen iskuulka iyo sida ay maaragtay intay iskuulka soo dhiganayeen waxyaaladii ay ka hadleen waxa kamidaha xaflada oo isoo jiitay buug kamida buug bay qoreen caruurtu grade 12 buugas oo ku daabaceen dareenkooga waxyeelada adduunka ka dhacay oo ay ku soo bandhigeen meesha waxyeelada kale la soo bandhigay waxa kamidaha oo ugu muhiimsan caruurtu sida aqoontooda ugu dhagan yihiin iyo islaamnimadooda ay ugu dhagan yihiin afar shii oo caruurtu ay wax ku mutaysteen waxa kamida yaani afkan ingiriiska waxa lagu yiraahdaa integrityga honestyga iyo hard work afarta qaybood oo maaragtay ay caruurtu ku soo bandhigeen markii ay hadliyeen waxaa kaloo iga yaabiyay oo caruurta aan marka aan fiiriyay caruurtu sidii u dhan yihiin scholarship bay wada heleen waxay heleen yacni iskoolada bibliga haddaa tagto nambar yaroo kooban ayaa helaa maaragtay lacagtan jaamacaduhu ay bixiyaan laakiin intii arday meesha isisoo taagtay nin walba wuxuu helay yacni award buu helay oo meel fiican buu iska taagay waxaa kale oo mataqaanaa igu cajiib badnaa caruurtii ka baxday sanadadii hore oo hadda qaarkood ay shaqeeyaan qaarkoodna ay jaamacadaha weli sii wataan oo weli iskoolkii ku fikiraya sidii ay wax dib u gelin lahaayeen taana meesha xafladda ayay iga taabatay oo wax cajiiba ayay ahayd inuu ilmuhu meeshii uu wax ka bartay inuu dib u soo eego oo uu yidhaaho jiilka dambe ee soo socda waynaan wax gashanaa haba ahaato symbolic ahaato waxyeelada kale haddana arrinta kale ay taabato waxay ka mid ahay inay sameeyeen inay iyagu isxilqaameen ardaydii ka baxday iskuulka oo ay ugu tala galeen ardayda ka baxaysa inay siiyaan reward lacaga sannadkii caruurtii qalin jabisay taana waxay ahayd arrin meesha ku wanaagsanayd oo laakiin arrinta la isweydiinaya ee muhiimka waxay tahay iskuulkani ma koobi karaa baahida dadka muslimiinta ee ku nool magaalada Ottawa su-aashaas jawaabteedu waa maya waayo dadka muslimiinta ee ku nool magaalada Ottawa 1 million baa ku nool muslimiintuna way tiro badan yihiin soomaalida ayaa tiradoodu ay badan yihiin dadku soddon kun ay ku tilmaamaan haddii xitaa soddonka la gaadhsiiyo ma buuxinayaan inta arday ee public schoolka dhigata dadka muslimiinta iyo inta arday halkan way kala aad bay u kala fulgiyen marka mashruucan hadda socda ee dhismuhu ku socdo wuxuu noo sahli doonaa in waddankan Canada laba arrimood baa ayaa muhiima waxaa lagu hadlaa laba af afna waa ingiriis afna waa faransiis labada af ayaa waddankan u ah afafka muhiimka u ah ee lagaga shaqeeyo waxaan raadinaynaa haddii Ilaahay noo saamaxo iskuulkan marka uu dhismihiisu dhammaado in aan kala saarno primary school iyo high school ay u kala baxaan oo hadhow toola ay noqoto laga yaabaa ilaa 800 arday ilaa 1000 ardayba ay noqoto caruurta ka dhiganaysa iskuulkan oo taana u sahasho jiilka dambe ee caruurta soo kacaysa in iskuulkani u buuxin karo baahidaas sidaa niba darteed baan anagu u raadinaynaa imika mashruuca noo socda oo ilaa 4 million ay ku baxayso milyuun iyo 300,000 already aan bixinay aan raadinaynaa maaragtay in gurmad dadka muslimiintu ay la soo gaaraan iskuulka laakiin gebi ahaan haddaad xafladda isku soo duudubto isha macalinee xafladdu aad iyo aad bay wanaagsanayd waana markii 13-aad ee la qabanqaabinayo imika waxayna bilaabantay 2004 13 sannadoodna way soo socotay waxaan u malaynayaa haddeeta waan qaan gaadhnay hore baan u soconaynaa inshaa Allah.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله محمد أنا مقعي وحوي عبد الرحمن علي عبدي أما عبد الرحمن علي متان وحنكا هاي بورك أوتوا إسلامي سكول فيس برسلان كانكا هاي إلهي سبحانه وتعالى أنا وحنا قلنا معي في آخرة وحوح نوترا وسكول كهدين إنه هاي أمد إسلامك أما أمد الصومالي ده قارهان for the last 25 years وحي أقوبتنا إعانو قبسنة وحوي أوتوا إسلامي سكول وحنا ما أنت أدين كدليل تدكي شوي إيو إنتان أرجع أركض دون تعجل ده هم بق قروح ده أي قبسة مدة صومالي ده أدوة دجن إسكول خمسة ميسي وحبر الشدة إيو تعلين توامل والله حلا لكن لبشي وأن ملك للجهة لي بانو كهل هلك ما أنت أرضي دي كبر موصي هلك هكالقلين شيء بس إنك يجيبه كتشري inanka horreysay ba jirtay oo ka qalin jabisay oo hadda jaamacadda fasalkii afraad gashay waxaan laga heleyn sida jeermaanka ama birishanka boardku sheegay een xaqi aqeedada oo caruurti environment islam ama chawl islam ay ku barbaarayaan waxa kale oo khaasatan oo aan meel kale laga heleyn 90% ardayda halka joogta waxa weeye waa dad madow waa Soomaali bay u badan yihiin waxay ka helaan waad arkaysa ardayga kasoo baxay Ottawa Islamic School kalsooni ma yaqaan inuu minority yahay ma yaqaan inuu color leeyahay waxa weeye waa Soomaali waa proud we haqa tacliintana oo Ilaahay og yahay waxa weeye Ottawa markay tagaan U ama Carleton waa la yaqaan ardayda Ottawa Islamic School xisaabta haddu ku wanaagsan ama science waxay u dhin jireen Ottawa Islamic School bad kasoo baxay intaas waa ee introduction en hadaba waxa kale de principalki ba ka hadlay oo presidentki ba ka hadlay oo hadii ee bid mahayo maanta qodobadii graduation ka laga akhriyay inaagti MBA ga ahayd kamid ahayd e community geenu kamid aha de waa maqlaysan ku noqon maayo laakiin waxa aynu soo qabsanay e ku halka soo gaarsiinay maanta hadana wax badan boo dhiman farriinta aan marka anigu ku dari lahaa waxa weeye war North America institution lamida oo kan oo kale kuma haysano oo Soomaali ay wada qabsatay oo aan isku qabqabsan oo aan qabiil lahayn wajillaahi oo kaliya aan waxa weeye hawl badan buu u baahan yahay maanta halba noo qalan hadii hashu reerka ay hashi ka ama awrku ka jabo waxa weeye hilibkii sidii loo dabari lahaa waa in qalmaan tahay halba noo qalan iskuul gaara ilaahay khayr hasiyo boardkii naga horeeyay principalka waalidinta waxa la bilaabay iskuulka arkaysan ee cusub ee xagga dambe wax badan waa laga qabtay wax badan way noo dhibay waxan qabaa hadii muslimiintu ama afrika ha joogto ama halkan ha joogto een haday nala qabtaanay wax badan ka bedeli doonto oo ilaahay subhanahu wa ta'ala wuxuu yiri man dal ladii yaqridu allah qardan hasana bal ilaahay qofka wax deeninaya $10 deemsada ee iskuulka ku darsada ee ilaahay 700 oo goor u laban laabayo waa wax ajiiba waa wax fi aakhiraba anigu maalintii aan soo galay boardka ila dooranay anigu midun baan soo gal magac uma soo gelin een hadii ee bid ma hayo maslahad gaar ah uma soo gelin ilaahay wajigiisa soo gal ee qolada boardkuna way fadhiya maalintii platformki aan soo dhigay waxay ahayd war inagii gabowney 30 sano in hadda halka la soo jiifnay caruurtii ka baxday halka caruurtoodii ba dhiganaysa hadda bilowday marka waxna ka codsanaya umada islaamka ee meel kasta ba joogeen war $10 waa lacag walaalayaal nagu caawiya generationa dambe oo iskuulka isticmaali doona kontanka kane soo socda si aynu u wada gaadhno qof kasto Soomaalina wuxuu noqonayaa wuxuu ku yahay dhaw
assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh magacayga waa maxamed mayo aadan waxaan ka mid ahay boardiga new boardiga of school marka waxaan u hambalyeynayaa graduation ki maanta oo ka dhacay Algonquin College oo ardaydii high school ka grade 12 wuxuuna ahaa graduation at نوسو جيتي وآدو فينا ما شاء الله ما شاء الله مركا أنا جا واحد بدن مرة هاي وحلاقي هاي أمد الصوماليات يدمان مسلمين تا سكول كان OIS أو إسلامي سكول وحول دقمة أنا قبضن كيا وحكو صوبرني وزارة التربية والتعليم قفكي سكول صوبرتي إنتاس أيو قوة دي أبصومالي أنا كوشي جو ووزارة وحبرشة هي بربارين تا ويا واحد ساس ولا هاي سكول كان وأسكول ككلية وإلمها أخلاق ذودي وشنت صلاة ذود هذي وصو قشو أنت وأسكول كجو واللجو جيني وحبرشة واللجو أديميو واللي هي سو وسيستا وكالي صلاة دي وسو استاجا وقبل دي حجابا تهاي ويلكي ودرس ومعنا ولباس في عنو وتو وما ننتي جمعها وصو قشنا يثوبكي أما خميسكي وأستانتي مسلمين تا كم وقتو إسلام مر كانوا وحبرش أهان أنا جا مدة أيان سكول كان فلانتير كأها سنة كان أمبان كم من نقطة إيش هيك ديجا بورد ديجا لكن أول وحنا ها فلانتير المهور رأي ديجاني هذا لمد وحاي ديكتا وسنة كان جريد إيد كبحي وسنة تدم بنقونا هاي سكول مر كا وسكول أدل وقف أيدي وما تا وحي كم وقتة حفلة دي لأن يردي كبحذي أي قار دولة أوش غيّة قار ومعلمين سكول كمعلمين قار جامعة مدينة وحكا برتان وكسو نقضى انت معلم كأها ومركا وسكولات مهمة مركا نفتي ذا يؤمد الصومالية إذا ما المسلمين تا وحن كبرين ايا وحن نوفر مي مشروع صب وهاي سكولة وهدي ونوها قاقو إله إذن كيسي لبا سكول أي نقونا يا وهل معمولة سكول كانوا نقولنا يدوكسي لحاء يدوكسي هوسي يو حنانا دي يو كاسو هاي سكولة وولي بالمشروعات وينا وليه وجيم كي ماشي المي باسبول كو عياري يو واحو البا مركبونو بلوضي ميل في عانو مريا لكن آنيقا أسي بورد آهان وحان اوغا هاي إن غالة لو بهاي مركا ولا ليالو وحان يدوكو بورينا آنيقا ينفتي دبا يو ننكسو مسلنا إنا تكاقي بغادتان مشروعات وهو أنفعيا ومدى مسلمين تا ملك سوئي جوكتو سبيشالي ومدى مسلمين تا كنو الأوتوا سكول كان ماها سكول ومدى صوماليات كليا لكتان جنسي ذا بدنا لكتا وعرب إلاه ذا وإيشيان كإليهين مركا إلهي هكا أجر سيو تدكي سوء أساسي وأسوء غريبي وإلا هير كان سوء قارتي أنا كان واحد واجب نقوة إنا المعنى وحي كران كينا أن قرب استاقنو مركا انتاسان وبحي
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم magacay goorto waxa la yiraahdaa Umar Maxamed Cabdulle laakiin Umar Cabdulle la yaqaan Ottawa Islamic School sanooyin badan ayaan macna hawlaheeda ku jiray alxamdulillaah yani muddadii aan iskuulkan soo joognay taariikh dheer buu iskuulka leeyahay waxaan iskuulka aniga u qaabilsanahay la taliyaha dhinaca amaaliyada baan iskuulka ka ahay isla markaana waxaan iskuulka maamulaa wixii ku saabsan shaqaalaha mishaaradooda bixinta wixii xisaabaad oo iskuulka la xiriira kontroolkooda iyo nidaamintooda baan qaabilsanahay wixii xisaabaad koodan baan iskuulkaasi soo waday muddo dheer baan iskuulkan la soo shaqeynayay 12 sano muddo ah muddadaas aan iskuulka soo shaqeynayay iskuulkan wuxuu soo maray taariikh dheer oo dhinaca dhaqaalaha ah sheeg marka aan taariikhdiisi hore la fahmo markaas baa qofkii fahmaya meesha uu maanta marayo iskuulka wuxuu soo maray marka imaneeyay waqti dhaqaalaha ee dukaamaha Soomaaliga ee walaalayna hilib xalaalyada lagu gado in la tago iskuulkan lacagtii mishaarka shaqaalaha la siin lahaa qaar meesha laga raadiyo si iskuulka loo soo kabo oo aaga baxo waxa dhacday in iskuulka waqtiga wuxuu lahaa charity status oo liiraado iskuulka si loogu ogolaado inuu dhaqaale ka aruriyo dadka waxa loo baahan yahay wadankana sida sharciga idinka dhanbadankiina ala socotaan inuu heesto ogolaasho uu ka heesto dawladda in uu arintaa sameeyo markaana waxay leedahay sharciyo badan oo adag oo qofka laga doonay iskuulka ama hay'adda inay fuliso tiina ma suuragalin marka waxa dhacday in iskuulka laga qaado xaqi uu u lahaa arintaasi arinta school kaana wax weey school waa non for profit organization corporation away ama waa mid aan faa'iido qaybsi ahayn bu school kaan ku qoran yahay waa corporation or non for profit away oo Ontario ku register gareysan oo marka wax faa'iido la qaybsado aanan jirin oo wixii soo gala asaga lagu celiyo marka wuxuu ahaa non for profit ee charity bu aha charity baa laga qaaday dad kale oo marka aan Soomaali aheyn way ka shaqeyn jireen muddo markay Soomaalidu ku soo yara badatay dadkii Soomaalida ay u soo bateen waliba aniga ayaamihii uu walaalkayna Maxamed Dalmar uu principalka iskuulka ka naqday koorana waan ka shaqeyn jiray iskuulka markastaba la taliyaha dhinaca maaliyadda muddo badan marka dad kale oo Soomaali aan aheyn ay joogeen dadka baa caawin jiray oo dhinaca talooyinka xisaabooyinka la toosin jiray marna anigaaba shakhsi ahaan iskuulka joogay oo xisaabaadkeedii hayay ilaa aan markii dambadii la taliyay iskuulka dhinaca maaliyadda naqdo oo dadkii walaalaha Soomaalida markay yimaadeen oo iskuulkii xaaladiisi ay yara adkaatay oo baan markaas bilownay inaan isgarab qabsano oo aan iskuulkii dee u soo celino xisaabaadkiisii wixiisa toosino dhaqaalihiisa sidii uu ku kucubi lahaa ka shaqeyno arin dee habeeno badan nagu qaadatay juhdi badan la geliyey oo markii hore marka la raadiyay xataa ilaa loo yiray meelo badan loo garaacay aad u adkayd in la soo saaro in iskuulka loo helo loo soo celiyo charity-giisa alxamdulillaahi dadaal weyn oo arintaa loo galay oo walaalnimo ah iyo soomaalinimo iyo muslimnimo ah iyo ilaahay daraadiisa la soo garab qabsaday ninka walaalkeena hadda iskuulka haddana principalka walaalkeen Maxamed Sheekh Axmed Dalmar iyo anigaba arintaa runtii waxaydanay ilaahayna subxaana wa tacaala la kaashanay wuxuuna noo suurageliyay in iskuulkii charity-giisii loo soo celiyo xisaabaadkiisii iskuulka la toosiyo oo iskuulkii naqdo meel isku hagaagsan waxaa jirta iskuulkan waxaa ka shaqeysa ilaa iyo 10 qofood oo shaqaale ah baa ka shaqeysa oo maanta mishaarkooda ka qaata oo alxamdulillaahi oo guryahooda macnaha dee hawshooda ku wata oo marka ayaguna iskuulkan dee waxa mishaar ay u qaataan aanan dhameen waxay ayaga u dhigmaan laakiin ilaahay daraadiisa markaa ku shaqeeya laakiin 10 qofood shaqaale u dhow baa maamulkoodii iyo payroll-koodii iyo mishaarooyinkoodii iyo wuxuudii dhan iskuulkan lagu maamulaa dad badan oo tiro badan oo shaqaalaha iskuulaad kala mid ah dhowr qofood baa finance kaliya ka shaqeysa marka waa arin sidaad aragtaan ninka walaalaheena volunteer-ka ee board member-ka ah oo na garab haya walaalkeen Maxamed Sheekh Axmed oo principal-ka anigoo finance-ga haya iyo dad marka support-ta noo ah gabadha guidance-ga ayadana haysa staff adiga la soo koobi karo ba iskuulkan oo dhan aragtaan oo intaas arday ka garaajgureynaysa hawsheeda wada alxamdulillaahi de ilaahi subxaana wa tacaala miisaankiisa iyadoo la xisaabayo ummadda Soomaaliyeed iyadoo isgarab haysata iskuulkan wuxuu ka tirsan yahay meelaha maanta laga qaadan karo tilmaamaha ee amar ku taamay inay ummadda Soomaaliyeed oo dhan sidaas oo kale u wada shaqeeyaan aniga iyo waxa ugu horeysa ninka maanta principalka iskuulkan ka iskuulkan baa isku baranay nimba meel buu ka yimid laakiin meel maanta sambal ah Soomaali dhinac kastaba ka timid inay isu imaatay oo kaliya isugu timid inay ilaahay daraadiisa ay caruurtaasi iyo Soomaali weyn ay gacanta inay isqabsadaan ayagoo aan isu eegaynin adigu halkee ka timid iyo adiga yaa tahay iskuulkan nooc kasta ka shaqeeya oo dad ah kulligoodana waxaa lagu wada shaqeeyaa ilaahay daraadiis iyo soomaalinimo iyo muslimnimo lagu wada shaqeeyaa ilaahayna taas buu nagu gargaaray waa meel tilmaamo laga qaato waa iskuul ay kontroolan yihiin wixii financialkiisa oo dhan ay kontroolan yihiin weeye alxamdulillah maalin kastana waxaa la gaaraa arrimo horumar ah meeshaas aan idiin sheegay uu ka soo bilowday maantana wuxuu marayaa وبالله الحمد إلهي دذالك والدينتا أي سمينيان أما بوردها أهادين أما إسكول كعرورها أولكتين وهبين إمالين عراريا وشيرين كي أيقا أي ما أنت دي داد كينو دانوا سيدة سعوتين وداد اسكا دقالة دحاضة بيقف كستبو حكود دذاليا إسكول كان meeshu wax kaga qaban laha qaar sambuusiga wax noo sameeya oo finance-iga dhinacoodi soo garab istaaga qaar marka iskuulki wax kala daahin wixii ay meel kale taa ayagu u baahnaayeen iskuulka ka hormariya hormarkaas weyn iskuulka waxaan gaarnay heer maanta alxamdulillaah weli meeshii la rabi dhaqaale ma gaarsiisana laakiin maanta maalin ay shaqaalihii aan u sameynay inay leeyihiin ee caafimaad ama health coverage bay shaqaalahayn oo dhan iskuulka ee macalimiinta waxaan u sameynay caafimaad bay leeyihiin 10 bilood ay ka shaqeeyaan ayna ka warwareynin juhdi badan ba arintaa naftigeeda la geliyay iskuulkan marka dhaqaalihiisa meel kale uu wax ka soo gala haba yaraatee ma jiraan wax dowlad siisa ma jiraan waxa waalidiinta iskuulka lacaga ay bixiso unba iskuulkaas oo dhan lagu wadaa taa unba iskuulkan lagu wadaa marka alxamdulillaahi rabbil caalamiin waxaanu sameynay hadda arrin kale oo la yiraahdo education orphan education fund for orphan education arrin la dhahan haddanu sameynay oo ah caruurta agoonta ah ee iskuulkan dhigta ee wax ku baranaya in laga caawino wixii la kari karo oo waxbarashadoodii ku saabsan in markaa dee wax laga ximilkaas badan laga qaado oo wixii la kari karo mashruuc noocaasaa la bilaabay hadda sanadkan 2015-2016 ka bishii u dambeysay iskuul yarka wixii waalida iskuulkan caruur agoon u dhiganaysay fiiga waa laga cafiyey lacagtaasna dee communitygun baa markaa iyadana laga reys gareeyey fandigaana waxaan rabnaa insha allahu tacaala inaan sii ballaarino oo aan hore isagan u wadno alxamdulilaahi hadda iskuulkii charitygiisii waa loo soo celiyey waagii hore dee meel aan charitygii haysanin ama numbarkaas haysanin dee qofkii waxuma siin karin way adkayd markii arinta albaabka furmay bay noqotay in iskuulkii uu helo dee inuu dadkii taxi receipt siin karo inuu maaragtay uu lacag badan keeni karo dee alxamdulillah haddana waa kaa mashruucaas ilaa 4 million a bilowday maantana meel fiican marayo weli u baahan yahay caawinaad badan cid kaleeto iskuulka u maqan oo aan ka ahayn in la isku duubto weliba waxaan ku dhiirigelinayaa ummadda soomaaliyeed inay macnaha isku tiirsadaan waa meel walaalahooda wada joogaan alxamdulillah waa wax maanta ummadda soomaaliyeed meel ay soomaali wada maamusho ay ama principal ha ahaado ama finance ha ahaado iskuulkan wax oo banaanka nalaga sameeyo ma jiro intaa ka shaqeysa iyo waxa la sameeyo dhan maamulkeeda iskaagideeda even boardigayna hadda kulli waa dad soomaaliyeed weeye dadkoo dhan waa dad isku af ku hadlaya meel ka yimid oo kulligooda ilaahay daraaddiis isu kaashanaya waxa videoga aad ka arkaysaan ama graduation waxa weeye gacanta iyo gacanta la saari bay ku imanaysaa markaan dhinacii dhaqaalaha si toos ah gooni ah u noqdo ilaa 50 employee meel ay ka shaqaynayso oo alxamdulillaahi dee ilaahay subxaanahu wa tacaala dad ayagana aada u wada dadaalaya yihiin oo ilaahay daraaddiisa ku sabraya oo laakiin very high qualified dad aada wax u soo bartay wada ah ama kii maamul xafiiseed finance ahaado ama kii principal ahaado ama kii waxbaraya ama kii boardigo volunteer ku shaqaynaya dadkoo dhan waxa weeye dad maanta qofkii meel kala raadsanaya wax ka wanaagsan kala raadsan kara laakiin ilaahay daraaddiisaa loo wada joogaa ilaahay baa lagu tiirsan ummaddayna soomaaliyeedna waxaa laga doonayaa maadaama uu t v-geyna af soomaali ku baxayo inay kaashadaan oo iskuulkaasi ay soo garab istaagaan oo inuu iskuulkoodayaa wixii la sameynayo maadaama meeshii qofkii ugu sarreeyo boordiga ah aan shilin iskuulkan ka qaadanayn oo markaana volunteer ugu shaqaynayo kuwii shaqaynayana ay wax yar ku shaqaynayaan in la iskaashado oo gacanta la issaaro oo mashruucaasna aan dhammayno baa loo baahan yahay oo qof kastaba uu iskuulkii soo garab istaago oo wixii tala a uu ku soo darsado waa loo wada dhaga furan yahay qof kastaa loo dhaga furan yahay in saa laisu garab qabto dhinacii kale finance iskuulka hadda registration uu bilaabay sanadka cusub 2016-2017 iskuul yeerka mar horaa la bilaabay registration-kaas iskuulka la bilaabay weli wuu socdaa galaasyada badana way buuxaan inta iskuul oo maanta kaynoo kale u dhiganta oo dee weliba gareedyo hoose ah iskuul siduu markii hore principalka sheegay iskuul meesha ilaa iyo high school ah oo cunug ina junior keento ilaa ee dugsi sare ka baxayo meeshan kuma yaalo ee iskuulka iskuulada kale ee jira way naga lacag badan yihiin hatta fiiga ardayda laga qaado uu badan yahay hada iskuul yarkan waxa la sameeyay iskuulka in ee waalidinta maadaama mashruuca say iskuulka la dhisayo oo la yiri qof kale uma maqra bal waalidinta in aan 500 la iska qaado si aan iskuulkaas u dhisano iskuulka waalidinta xaruurtooda soo naqanayso boordi waxay go'aan gaareen in laga cafiyo sanadkan inayna bixinin iskuulka is register guarantee lacagti laga qaadi jiray waxa la yiri lacagtay bixinayaan un maartay mashruucaas oo iska sadaqo jaariya oo xaruurti loogu talagalay ku bixiyaan marka walow iskuulkii baahi jirto operational ah haddana boardigiisa si waalidkiina lagu caawino kooskii kale lagu caawino iskuulka registration-kiisa ama isjiridiisa wax dadka badanaa way soo wada qoreen dhaqsiina waxa laga yaabaa inuu liiska iska buuxsiyay markuu ku encourage gareynayo qof kastaba inuu wixii faahfaahin ah oo loo baahdo iskuulkeena finance xafiis uu leeyahay oo finance office ah xafiiskaas baa teker gareeya amaba ka howlgalo waan anigu mas-uul ka ahay shakhsiyan wax allaala wixii ku saabsan dhaqaale iskuulkan cash lagama bixiyo waa iskuul financial control-kiisa ee outstanding ah cash lagama bixiyo wixii la bixinayo dhan waa check system baan leenahay payroll system baan leenahay adag ee shaqaaleyna waxay leeyihiin system electronic ah oo markay shaqada soo galaan markay ka baxaan record of employment-igooda waa iskuul u shaqeeya any other school oo legitimate oo system-kiisa dhisan yahay iskuulaad kale private-kana ayba sample-ka qaadan karaan marka alxamdulillah wa ilaahi mahadiisa intaasna wax weeye ummadda soomaaliyeed waxay leeyihiin dad aada aqoon u leh waxay leeyihiin karti badan waxay leeyihiin kaliya waxa loo baahan yahay waxa weeye inaan iskaashanno oo iskuulkeenaas steepka aan maanta ka soo qaadnay meel ka weyn uu maanta maraya inaan garbaha inaan isqabsanno oo aan ma aragtay hadduu cunug kuu dhiganaya iyo hadduuna cunug iskuulka kuu dhiganaynba hadduu iskuulkaaga hadduu maanta cunug kuu dhiganayn beri waxaa laga yaabaa inuu cunug kuu dhigto hadduuna kuu dhigano waxaa laga yaabaa beri cunugaaga wax dhigtay inuu iskuulka naftigiisa ka shaqeeyaba oo macalin ka naqdaa laga yaabaa marka waxaan ku dadaalaynaa communitiga ishaas u ifaysa ee communitiga waa muslimiinta qaar baa waxayna yidhaahdaan iskuulkaas Ottawa Islam School haddaad soomaali tihiin waxaad ka dhignayd manaarad ummadda muslimiinta a meesha u taagan annagu way naga go'an tahay boordiga way ka go'an tahay principalka way ka go'an tahay macalimiinta way ka go'an tahay inaan iskuulkaas ilaahay subxaanahu wa tacaala daraaddiisa inaan iskuulkaasi hore u wadno idinkana waxaa idinka doonaynaa inaadna support garaysaan inaad na soo garab istaagtaan jazaakum allahu khayra wasalaamu calaykum waraxmatullahi wabarakaatu
bismi illaahi raxmaan iraxiim magacayga waxaa la yidhaahdaa caamir maxamuud maxamed wiilkayga maxamed maxamuud ayaa garaajid gareeyey waxaan ka mid ahay board of directors oo Ottawa Islamic School waa ilaahay mahadi xafladii maanta si fiican bay noogu dhacday waa glaaskii 2016 waa ilaahay mahadi iskuulkan wiilkayga wuxuu bilaabay isaga oo maaragtay grade 2 ah haddana wuu garaajid gareeyey waa iskuullada ugu fiican ee magaaladan Ottawa waa iskuul islaamiga ummadda soomaaliyeed iyo ummadda muslimka ayaa mahadaas iska leh ilaahay xamdigii weeye programkii maanta wuxuu noogu dhacay si aad iyo aad u fiican haddaan iskuulka warbixin idin ka siiyo iskuulka waxaa ka socdaa dhismo dhismahaasoo u baahan in muslimiinta ay ka qayb qaataan projectigaas waa project weyn waxaa ku baxaya lacag ilaa 4 million gaaraysa 2 million ilaa hadda waan yacni constructionka waa socdaa ummadda muslimiinta meel walba ay joogaan waxaan ka codsanaynaa inay wixii karaamadooda ay nagu gargaari karaan si aan iskuulkaas u dhammayno qaybo badan ayaa naga maqan iskuulka ayaan insha allah ku dari doonaa waxaa ka mid ah lab waxaa ka mid ah gym caruurta ay ku ciyaaraan waxaa ka mid ah library marka inta muslimiinta adduunka daafaheeda ku nool oo dhageysanaysa wareysigan waxaan ka codsanayaa inay maareeyto wixii karaamadooda ay maareeyay ka geysan karaan iskuulkan inay ka geystaan waa iskuul qurux badan waa iskuul muslim ah waxa waan ku asturanahay magaaladan Ottawa dadka jooga oo muslimiinta ah waa iskuul ay majority ay dhigtaan caruur Soomaaliyeed Arab muslim waa loo dhanyahay marka waa Ilaahay mahadi وانا مع حسنتين السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته
Give thanks to Allah for the moon and the stars Praise Him all day for what is and what was Take hold of your iman Don't give in to shaitan Oh you who believe please give thanks to Allah Allahu ghafoor Allahu Rahim Allahu yuhibbul muhsinin Wa khaliquna Wa raziquna Wa huwa ala kulli shay'in qadir Allah is ghafoor Allah is Rahim Allah is the one who loves the muhsinin He is our creator, He is our sustainer, and He is the one who has power over all. Give thanks to Allah for the moon and the stars. Praise Him all day for what is and what was. Take hold of your iman, don't give in to shaitan. Oh, you who believe, please give thanks to Allah. Allahu ghafoor, Allahu rahim, Allahu yuhibbul muhsinin, wa khaliquna, wa raziquna, wa huwa ala kulli shay'in qadir. Allah is ghafoor, Allah is rahim, Allah is the one who loves the muhsinin. He is our creator, He is our sustainer, and He is the one who has power over all. Give thanks to Allah for the moon and the stars. Praise Him all day for what is and what was. Take hold of your iman, don't give in to shaitan. Oh, you who believe, please give thanks to Allah. Allahu ghafoor, Allahu rahim, Allahu yuhibbul muhsinin, wa khaliquna, wa raziquna, wa huwa ala kulli shay'in qadir. Allah is ghafoor, Allah is rahim, Allah is the one who loves the muhsinin. He is our creator, He is our sustainer, and He is the one who has power over all. Give thanks to Allah for the moon and the stars. Praise Him all day for what is and what was. Take hold of your iman, don't give in to shaitan. Oh, you who believe, please give thanks to Allah. Allahu ghafoor, Allahu rahim, Allahu yuhibbul muhsinin, wa khaliquna, wa raziquna, wa huwa ala kulli shay'in qadir. Allah is ghafoor, Allah is rahim, Allah is the one who loves the muhsinin. He is our creator, He is our sustainer, and He is the one who has power over all. Give thanks to Allah for the moon and the stars. Praise Him all day for what is and what was. Take hold of your iman, don't give in to shaitan. Oh, you who believe, please give thanks to Allah. Allahu ghafoor, Allahu rahim, Allahu yuhibbul muhsinin, wa khaliquna, wa raziquna, وهو على كل شيء قدير الله is غفور الله is رحيم الله is the one who loves the محسنين He is our creator, He is our sustainer, and He is the one who has power over all. Give thanks to Allah for the moon and the stars. Praise Him all day for what is and what was. Take hold of your iman, don't give in to shaitan. Oh, you who believe, please give thanks to Allah. Allahu Ghafoor, Allahu Rahim, Allahu Yuhibbul Muhsinin, Huwa Khaliquna, Huwa Raziquna, Wa Huwa Ala Kulli Shay'in Qadir. Allah is Ghafoor, Allah is Rahim, Allah is the one who loves the Muhsinin. He is our creator, He is our sustainer, and He is the one who has power over all. Give thanks to Allah for the moon and the stars. Praise Him all day for what is and what was. Take hold of your iman, don't give in to shaitan. Oh, you who believe, please give thanks to Allah. Allahu Ghafoor, Allahu Rahim, Allahu Yuhibbul Muhsinin, Huwa Khaliquna, Huwa Raziquna, Wa Huwa Ala Kulli Shay'in Qadir. Allah is Ghafoor, Allah is Rahim, Allah is the one who loves the Muhsinin. He is our creator, He is our sustainer, and He is the one who has power over all. Give thanks to Allah for the moon and the stars. Praise Him all day for what is and what was. Take hold of your iman, don't give in to shaitan. Oh, you who believe, please give thanks to Allah. Allahu Ghafoor, Allahu Rahim, Allahu Yuhibbul Muhsinin, Huwa Khaliquna, Huwa Raziquna, Wa Huwa Ala Kulli Shay'in Qadir. Allah is Ghafoor, Allah is Rahim, Allah is the one who loves the Muhsinin. He is our creator, He is our sustainer, and He is the one who has power over all. Give thanks to Allah for the moon and the stars. Praise Him all day for what is and what was. Take hold of your iman, don't give in to shaitan. Oh, you who believe, please give thanks to Allah. Allahu Ghafoor, Allahu Rahim, Allahu Yuhibbul Muhsinin, Huwa Khaliquna, Huwa Raziquna, Wa Huwa Ala Kulli Shay'in Qadir. Allah is Ghafoor, Allah is Rahim, Allah is the one who loves the Muhsinin. He is our creator, He is our sustainer, and He is the one who has power over all. Give thanks to Allah for the moon and the stars. Praise Him all day for what is and what was. Take hold of your iman, don't give in to shaitan. Oh, you who believe, please give thanks to Allah. Allahu Ghafoor, Allahu Rahim, Allahu Yuhibbul Muhsinin, Huwa Khaliquna, Huwa Raziquna, وهو على كل شيء قدير. Allah is Ghafoor, Allah is Rahim, Allah is the one who loves the Muhsinin. He is our creator, He is our sustainer, and He is the one who has power over all. Give thanks to Allah for the moon and the stars. Praise Him all day for what is and what was. Take hold of your iman, don't give in to shaitan. Oh, you who believe, please give thanks to Allah. Allahu Ghafoor, Allahu Rahim, Allahu Yuhibbul Muhsinin. Huwa Khaliquna, Huwa Raziquna, Wa Huwa Ala Kulli Shay'in Qadir. Allah is Ghafoor, Allah is Rahim, Allah is the one who loves the Muhsinin. He is our creator, He is our sustainer, and He is the one who has power over all. Give thanks to Allah for the moon and the stars. Praise Him all day for what is and what was. Take hold of your iman, don't give in to shaitan. Oh, you who believe, please give thanks to Allah. Allahu Ghafoor, Allahu Rahim, Allahu Yuhibbul Muhsinin. Huwa Khaliquna, Huwa Raziquna, Wa Huwa Ala Kulli Shay'in Qadir. Allah is Ghafoor, Allah is Rahim, Allah is the one who loves the Muhsinin. He is our creator, He is our sustainer, and He is the one who has power over all. Give thanks to Allah for the moon and the stars. Praise Him all day for what is and what was. Take hold of your iman, don't give in to shaitan. Oh, you who believe, please give thanks to Allah. Allahu Ghafoor, Allahu Rahim, Allahu Yuhibbul Muhsinin. Huwa Khaliquna, Huwa Raziquna, Wa Huwa Ala Kulli Shay'in Qadir. Allah is Ghafoor, Allah is Rahim, Allah is the one who loves the Muhsinin. He is our creator, He is our sustainer, and He is the one who has power over all. Give thanks to Allah for the moon and the stars. Praise Him all day for what is and what was. Take hold of your iman, don't give in to shaitan. Oh, you who
We'd like to call upon Zakaria Abdi Salam to do the closing dua during this blessed month of Ramadan.
Alhamdulillah, alladhi lam yakun lahu sharikun fil mulk, wa lam yattakhidh sahibatan wala walada. الحمد لله الذي هدانا للإسلام وآتانا من أمرنا رشدا الحمد لله الذي أعد للمؤمنين جنات خالدين فيها أبدا وأعد للكافرين جهنم لا يخرجون منها أبدا الحمد لله القائل في كتابه الحكيم وأما من أوتي كتابه بيمينه فيقول هاؤم اقرءوا كتابيه إني ظننت أني ملاق حسابيه سبحان الذي بكت من خشيته العيون سبحان الذي سجد له المصلون سبحان الذي أمره بين الكاف والنون سبحان الذي سبح بحمده الأولون والآخرون سبحان قاضي الحاجات سبحان فاطر السماوات سبحان الذي لا تختلف عليه اللغات سبحان من أمره بين الكاف والنون سبحان الذي في السماء عرشه سبحان الذي في الأرض سلطانه سبحان الذي في البحر سبيله سبحان الذي في جهنم سخطه سبحان الذي في الجنة رحمته سبحان ذي العزة والجبروت سبحان ذي القوة والملكوت سبحان ذي العظمة والكبرياء سبحان رافع السماء سبحان الله عدد الليل والنهار سبحان عدد المستغفرين بالأسحار سبحان الله عدد ما غرط طير وطار سبحان الله عدد الشجر والدواب والبحار سبحان الله والحمد لله ولا إله إلا الله والله أكبر اللهم اهدنا فيمن هديت وعافنا فيمن عافيت وتولنا فيمن توليت وبارك لنا اللهم فيما أعطيت وقنا واصرف عنا شر ما قضيت إنك تقضي بالحق ولا يقضى عليك إنه لا يذل من واليت ولا يعز من عاديت تباركت ربنا وتعاليت نستغفرك اللهم من جميع الذنوب والخطايا ونتوب إليك اللهم اقسم لنا من خشيتك ما تحول به بيننا وبين معصيتك ومن طاعتك ما تبلغنا به جنتك ومن اليقين ما تهون به علينا مصائب الدنيا ومتعنا اللهم بأسماعنا وأبصارنا وقواتنا أبدا ما أبغيتنا واجعله الوارث منا واجعل ثأرنا على من ظلمنا وانصرنا على من عادانا ولا تجعل مصيبتنا في ديننا ولا تجعل الدنيا أكبر همنا ولا مبلغ علمنا ولا إلى النار مصيرنا وارفع مقتك وغضبك عنا برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم إنا نسألك موجبات رحمتك وعزائم مغفرتك والسلامة من كل إثم والغنيمة من كل بر والفوز بالجنة والنجاة من النار برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم اغننا بحلالك عن حرامك وبطاعتك عن معصيتك وبفضلك عمن سواك يا واسع المغفرة اللهم اغفر لنا في يومنا هذه أجمعين وهب المسيئين منا للمحسنين اللهم نفس كرب المكروبين وقض الدين عن المدينين واشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم اجعلنا من عتقائك من النار اللهم اجعلنا من عتقائك من النار اللهم اكتبنا في عليين وأعطنا كتابنا باليمين واجعلنا من المرحومين ولا تجعلنا من المحرومين برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم إنك عفو كريم تحب العفو فاعف عنا اللهم إنك عفو كريم تحب العفو فاعف عنا اللهم إنا نسألك رضاك والجنة ونعوذ بك من سخطك والنار برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا كلها دقها وجلها أولها وآخرها ما نسينا منها وما لم ننساها برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم لا تدع لنا في مقامنا هذا ذنبا إلا غفرته ولا هما إلا فرجته ولا دينا إلا قضيته ولا أسيرا إلا فككته ولا أسيرا إلا فككته ولا مبتلا إلا عافيته ولا ميتا إلا رحمته ولا شابا إلا أصلحته ولا ضالا إلا هديته. اللهم أصلح شبابنا وشيوخنا، اللهم اهد فتياتنا وعجائزنا، اللهم حبب إليهم الإيمان وزينه في قلوبهم وكره إليهم الكفر والفسوق والعصيان يا رب العالمين. اللهم وفق شبابنا وفتياتنا للتمسك بالدين، اللهم وبغض إليهم المعاكسات وتتبع الشهوات والملذات والخلوة في الخطيئات والوقوع في المحرمات. اللهم اجعلهن ممن تاب إليك واناب في هذا الشهر الكريم يا رب العالمين. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين. وصل اللهم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم.
intaasi ayaan ku soo gabagabeynayna daawadayaal barnaamijkeena ee codka jaaliyadda Kanada. inta todobaadka xiga aan ku kulmi doono barnaamijka kale anigu ah Muhiuddin Jaamac nabadgelyo.